Hey everybody, we're about to get started with this thing. Naomi is texting things on her phone and turning her microphone on. Are you on, my love?
I am on. I'm saying hello to everybody out there. Welcome to our living room. I am just making sure that we share with people on Instagram right now.
That is right. Instagram is going to get the weird setup, but maybe some behind the scenes action as well. Who knows?
Peter, you want to talk about your disdain for vertical video, especially since they're not on here yet?
Well, I'm a Luddite and I'm new to technology and stuff. So, I mean, compared to the youth. So Instagram seems like a terrible place to watch a instructional video, but hey, go ahead. We're very happy to have you if you come. Guys, check out, we've got a cool little picture of Frankie up here in our used to be stained glass window over there. This is our dining room that we are welcoming you to. It's smaller than it looks. Man, it looks pretty small actually. But it's as clean as it's ever been. And sadly, probably no cameos for baby until maybe way later, but she's over with our grandparents, or her grandparents, our parents now, because we could not do any of this with her around. Wow, it's inconvenient. As you can see over here, we have solo jazz is gonna be up next. First, we have our Lindy Hop class, which is starting now. And then down here, this is where you can donate. The whole idea is that we are Lindy Hop teachers and we don't have a lot of other skills, y'all. So one of the ways we thought we could sort of do a little bit of good is just do a workshop. You guys could join us, come learn some fun stuff. And just instead of paying for the class, donate to these two great causes. So one cause is the Equal Justice Initiative. That's a really, really great national organization headed up by Brian Stevenson. You should check out his book, Just Mercy. There's a movie about his book coming out. They do great work on trying to end mass incarceration and just help people who've been unjustly punished and punished way too much for a long time. So they're really awesome national organization. And then because so much stuff has been going down in Minneapolis, we're going to be contributing to the Northside Achievement Zone as well. And they work to end generational poverty. And in Minneapolis, as everyone's kind of finding out, it's a really segregated town, even though I love it to death. And the Northside is where a lot of the African-American community was sort of pushed via redlining and a bunch of like building of highways and stuff. And a lot of economic opportunities left there a long time ago. And so the Northside Achievement Zone works with kids and their families in a sort of holistic approach to try and like raise people up and have them have a better future, basically. So those are the two things we're going to donate for. That is down, whoops, I'm not going to use this, it's down here.
That's okay.
Check it out. And we're going to do some stuff. We did a little stuff we made up and we got a little stuff we stole from Frankie because it's just such classic great stuff. So Naomi.
Hello.
Do you want to get started on this thing?
I would love to get started. Hi everybody. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, we'll take a couple breaks and we'll answer some questions during a little like 3-minute water break. We'll take two of those in this first class and two in the second class. But for now, we're just going to get going and we're going to assume that you're all getting it. I hope. So we're going to start out. We're going to kind of build a little routine that's mostly lead and follow stuff and it goes into some choreography. For now, we're going to do swing outs. On those swing outs, do you want to do your thing first?
Yes, a little something for the followers. So even if you don't have a partner at home, you can learn this variation right now.
Indeed. Or you know what? Just sit on the couch and eat ice cream. We don't know. Just donate some money. Here we go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
That's cool, Naomi. Why don't you teach it to us?
Oh,
and if you're
you.
A leader, why not learn it on the other foot?
All right. All we're doing is messing with the very end of the swing out. So my footwork's going to go like this.
Out of the way.
Rock, step, triple step, 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 and down. So I'm really going to jump to that 7, and then I'm going to hit it with that right foot without putting any weight on it. So I'm really going to jump and land without my weight on my right foot. Let's just try it.
Can you scooch it? I'll come in too.
Yeah. 5, 6, 7, 8. We go 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7. Nice.
Are we centered? I'm really worried about being centered. Pretty good.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7. So you want to make sure you get a little air on 6. I jump up on 6. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6. So that I can land on 7.
7 is one landing. 2 sounds, but one landing.
Let's try it a couple times in a row, everybody. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6. All right.
Let's try it in some swing outs. I would advise if you happen to have a partner at home, you're oh so lucky. Let's have the leaders do a couple basic ones and the followers give it a shot. This is sort of the follower variation. Of course, it can work for either party, but generally variations are tricky when we both do them together. Not always, but in this case, let's just have the leaders hold down a basic and the followers get funky.
It's my idea, so I get to try it.
Why don't you kind of count us? We'll do music later.
Okay, so just a bunch of swing outs?
Yeah, let's do at least 4.
Okay.
You tell me when to stop.
5, 6, here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. Swing out, followers, ooh, da, ba, da, ooh, da, 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 ooh,
you guys, I'm nailing it.
Da, ooh, da, da, ooh, da, da,
da, da, da, da.
Nice singing.
Yeah, thank you, thank you. That was really good. I think everyone got it.
I know. I'm like, oh, what are we doing?
That's a lot of practice. Why don't we do this just because we have this rhythm in our heads? Why don't we have the leaders try it for 1 second?
Yeah, right.
Yeah. So you'll do a basic. Okay. In case I blow it, you're keeping time at least. Let's all keep in mind while we watch this that I haven't practiced this and Naomi has. Here goes 5, 6, 7, 8. Pre-excusing.
One, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight.
What if we both did it to a little bit of music?
Okay.
For 1 second, yeah?
Sounds good.
Naomi's gonna play DJ, and you guys can just come along with us, try some swing outs, and I would say you can both try it at the same time, or it can be either leaders, either followers. Let's mix it up and sort of replicate a real life situation where somebody just has an idea and they bust it out.
Here we go.
I'm working on my heavy breathing. I've been in quarantine, y'all.
Is this too slow?
Not for me. Feel good. That's a quarantine tempo. Hey, as you wish, everybody. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Have you heard what I've done? Found the word, just the one that takes the place of one I used to call.
Oh my God.
Baby doll. It ain't new.
We can also do
it. Ain't old. But
oh my
if
God.
You do, as you're told, you'll find a letter if you take a look in Mr. Webster's dictionary book. The name is Sugar. I call my baby my sugar.
Let's end it there because I'm dying.
I never baby my sugar because my sugar.
We're calling
is
that
so
good, folks.
All right.
So we're going to do 2 swing outs on either one of those. Followers, try your thing. Leaders, maybe just get ready for what's coming next. You can try your thing if you want, but not mandatory. I'll be doing basics.
So we're doing 2 swing outs, und then?
Then we're gonna do a Texas Tommy, and if you don't know how to do a comfortable Texas Tommy yet, don't do one. So here's a Texas Tommy for you. Bop, 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 bop. Just like that. If you don't know how to do that, we don't wanna go into it in this one. We're gonna do a whole thing on our Patreon about Texas Tommy and like a whole treatise, so we can break it down. But it takes a long time, so I'll just say do a Texas Tommy, make sure it's comfortable, and leaders, check with your partner. If it's not comfortable, please stop doing it that way. And what you can do instead is just simply change your hands at the end of a swing out. Just change hands. We're just trying to get to there. So that's not a big deal. So I'm just saying do a Texas Tommy, we're not teaching it for now, okay? So 2 swing outs and a Texas Tommy, and then I'll show the next move.
All right.
Yeah? Swing out. That was 1.
That
Here's
was
2.
2.
Texas Tommy time, so cute. Then we go 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We are gonna link up here, link arms. So when we do this, the first thing we gotta get is just the turn.
The 8-count turn is actually pretty simple. I just think we're going back out to open position. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
And I think we should try it just like that without me turning and without any fancy arm link at the end. The idea is just to get a nice steady rate of rotation. And if Naomi's patient about it, she's much more easier for me to estimate where she's gonna be. She makes that a lot easier. So when I'm doing this, I bring the hand up and over and down and through. So why don't we try just that much one time, super simple. We're gonna start shaking hands. Mm-hmm. Going past your right side leaders, turning this way, which is counterclockwise. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again.
Let's do it and then let's not do a super fake teachy pose at the end.
Well, I mean, we're just stopping right now.
I mean, that's what I do. I'm like...
Everyone do your best fake teachy pose at the end. 5, 6, 7, 8. Hey.
Well, get ready.
Feel good. All right, so...
So it's a pretty simple 8-count move. There's no tuck in it. It just goes the same way the whole time. If I take it nice and slow and easy and I'm not worried about rushing through it, then it's a lot easier for Peter to surprise me and go to a new position at the end.
I should just say, before we get to that arm link at the end, I'm going to do a little turn on that. So I turn away from my lead.
Things
you
I
may
don't
or may not
know.
That.
Things I don't know because I'm turning.
So when I'm here, I'm going to go rock, step, triple step, whoop,
Look at you.
And then I'm coming back in, and I got to really change direction on that 5-6 and come back towards my partner on 7-8.
That's a bonus move.
And I'm just doing a little, like, a wave past the butt. Call it what you want, but my hand goes like that. So check it out. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Whoop. Bop, bop, bop. And then I'm trying to link up arms here. So I think what we should do is try and go to that position. And the one thing I would say when we're going to try and get to that arm length position, if I'm turning my left, when I'm coming through here, it's very easy, leaders, to go boom and try to make that connection. But because your follower's spinning into it and you're actually going to want them to keep coming forward, you more offer and wait than go clicking in there. Mm. So I really offer it up and I encourage my partner to come to me. So we'll show that as we move on, but let's just get to the arm link at all. So from here, 1-8 count move. Leaders, you turn the followers, and you're gonna turn to your own personal left, leaders. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 3, and 4, 5, link it up, bye-bye. So I'm moving close, but my arm, which you totally can't see because we're blocking it, is here. Why don't we do it this way one time and see if we can get a little better angle for them to see that link. Wait, maybe like this. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Kind of see it. So if I was pushing my arm forward, it's messing Naomi up. I want to let Naomi keep coming this away. Because then what we're going to do is kind of go around a circle.
Peter Strom, I think you're ahead of the game. Because if we were teaching real people in the room right now.
I'm not saying we're doing that next. I'm not doing that now.
I would just say there would be like 5 leaders who'd be turning the wrong way.
Oh, girl, I know it. I know it.
But which way are you turning?
My point is this. When we're here,
the
idea is like Naomi has to go this way because the next thing we do is not pushing your partner back. It's going forward is what I'm saying. Get off me. But let's go again and let's make sure all the leaders turn to their left. Okay? That's the main thing is to get this part first. 5, 6, 7.
To your left, leaders. To your left.
Was that your left? One more time. Your own personal left, which is this way. 5, 6, 7, 8.
You guys might notice I'm actually staying in the same place I would be for the normal 8 count turn where I'm coming out to open position and Peter's really coming to me. That's what makes it work in a social dance situation. I'm not coming to meet him. I don't know that we're going to make this arm connection.
Yeah. So now I think we should try to go to the next thing and maybe a little artificially. Am I crazy?
Or should we go from the top?
Okay, we can go from the top. Top. Then questions.
Okay.
Because we're getting to time for a little water break.
So true. We want to say hi in the chat.
So everybody, what does it start with? Let me hear it. That's right. 2 swing outs, then a Texas Tommy or hand change, and then we do the fancy move. So we're doing 4-8 counts of dancing. Here we go.
Got it.
Naomi, hit it.
5, 6, 7, 8, sugar. I call my baby my sugar. I never made me my sugar.
Texas Tommy.
Because my sugar.
Here we go, leaders. Turn to
so
your left. Go get your partner.
Let's do it again.
We did it. I'm always happy when it works.
You always go, yes.
Feels good. Here we go. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Funny. He never asks for my money. All that I give him is honey. That he can spend any time. Ba, 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 ba. I take one.
One more time with us, and we're going to continue on, and you don't have to.
Oh, look at us.
Now let's just go around.
Okay.
Here we go. One more. 5. So give me the bridge. 5, 6, 7, 8.
I'd take 1 million trips to his lips.
It's also a concert,
if
you guys.
If I were a bee, I should have warmed up. Very, very confectionary to me. Oh, he's confectionary.
And now you're walking,
sugar.
Walking.
I got my baby.
Taking a junky walk, y'all. And that's the rest of class. Everybody, what we're going to do is we're going to take a 3-minute water break. And when we do, we want you to type into the chat any questions you have. We will check those.
We'll be chatting with you guys as well. We're looking down, but we should be looking up like this.
So there'll be chat there.
Instagram,
it's showing up. Boom, boom,
hi.
Boom. Yep.
Okay.
We're on gonna, Instagram.
We're going to do this, but Instagram can still hear us.
Why don't you play a little music?
Such a great idea. All right, everybody. I guess it's no surprise, but all the music I'm playing today is by my band, Naomi and Her Handsome Devils. It's a little narcissistic, but it's also because we don't want to get kicked off any of the live platforms for doing copyrighted stuff. And I should just put out there while I'm getting the song ready that any swing dancers who want to use my band's music, Naomi and Her Handsome Devils, you're totally welcome to do it. You don't have to ask me permission. I'm happy to spread it around, and I love to see what you guys do. to the devil's music. Speaking of, I'm gonna play a little song called Boot Heel Drag.
Too kind, everybody. Naomi, is your mic on?
No, it is.
All right, everybody. So we got some questions. We're going to peep them out for you and go over these a little bit.
I'm excited to see them.
Okay. Oh, good note.
Hey, Jocelyn. Hi, Katie. This is just going to be all shout-outs. Hi, Val.
Just Mercy is
Valerie.
Streaming for free on Amazon Prime right now. So true. Check it out. It's also got my boy Michael B. Jordan, my celebrity crush.
That's true.
Okay, concise name for the type of kick step we're doing. We're circling with our elbows linked. I don't have a name for that.
Oh, a name? You can name it if you like.
It's in the Big Apple when they do this, but...
Oh, you mean when they're going around?
Yeah.
Like this?
I don't have it offhand, y'all. I'll have to check on that. I don't have it on hand.
We'll call that the Big Apple arm link, but you know what? I have a couple followers asking questions about doing the variation again. Either you came in a little late and you missed it, or you just need a little review. And also, Kelsey, you're talking about coming out of it, if you should swivel or rock step. Uh-huh. You can do either. I find that when I do a swivel, it is sometimes not the easiest transition, but it is possible. So let me just go over the footwork again, nice and slow, so you guys can catch it.
I'll watch you do that.
And then we'll practice the transition with our partner. So watch me. I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So when I jump up on 6, I'm landing down on 7 and what I'm doing is I'm smacking my right foot, but not putting any weight on it. So I'm just jumping and smacking my foot so I can pick it back up and rock step on my right foot.
And Naomi, are you trying to get your leg really straight or just try to make the sound?
That's a good question. I don't want it to be all sad, but I'm not doing like a big fancy super pose. If you guys want to do a fancy super pose, it's fine. My priority in this variation is to make a big old sound. I love making little rhythmic impression.
Yeah.
When it comes to variations.
And I think that keeps you in the groove really well. Like,
and
you stay in the swing out.
Yeah, and I think it freaks out my partners a little bit. So let me show it again. I'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up and down. Why don't you guys try that with me right now?
I'm gonna try it with you too, Kim.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we should be able to pick that same foot up and take a rock step.
What if we tried this? Do you do the little twist out of it? Do you tend to twist out of it?
You know, it's either or, and it's going to depend a little bit on how far away your partner is, but I can twist out of it, yes.
Yeah.
So we can practice that.
Why don't we try moving around with it then? Because the twist, they work so poorly when you're putting them in place, but they work so well when you're moving.
That's a good point. Let's not get ahead of ourselves, though, because some people might have joined a little later, and they might not have done it before. So
okay.
Let's do it 4 times in a row, just holding still.
You got it.
Holding our breath in our dining room. Here we go.
5, 6, 4
times in a row. We go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just like that. Now, because we're smacking our foot, I did sneak in a little double tap, but it's the same thing. We're not putting any weight on it, so you can make whatever sounds you like.
Naomi, people like names, and we don't have any. Do you have a name for this?
Let's call it the smack.
Sounds great.
Because I smack the floor. The smack or the double smack. So you want us to move around with it, which I think is a great idea.
Yeah.
Whenever you're working on variations, you want to make sure you move across the floor.
Especially followers, because you aren't going to plan where you're going next. Leaders might have a little more deciding power of where they go next.
And you know, I should mention, if you guys like these sort of rhythmic variations, little brain breakers, and you like moving across the floor and trying them in place, I actually just made a rhythm drill for our Patreon.
It's really cool.
I was very excited about it, and Kelsey, who asked the question about the transition, she actually said like, oh, this is pretty good, and then she was like, oh, Jesus, it gets harder and harder. You
well,
can choose your own adventure.
Like, I'm doing fine. I'm doing and then you're not doing fine. It's very challenging, and it's helpful.
So feel free to check out our Patreon.
Let's move around with this thing.
Okay.
I'm going to do rock steps. You can do twist twists.
Exactly.
I'm the 1-2 every time.
Exactly. So, should
we just put on a song or we just wander?
Song.
Take a wander with us, you guys.
I guess music's okay. I like music.
I'll just say this. I'm so happy if you're just sitting here like watching us on your couch.
That happens.
But then you should for sure donate. Should really, really donate.
Well,
bam, it's right over here.
Who,
little donation.
Who are they donating to? Just say the names of a couple.
Once again, it's Equal Justice Initiative. And it's the Northside Achievement Zone. Northside Achievement Zone is local. They're in Minneapolis, based on the Northside. And they're trying to end generational poverty. And they basically take kids. And to help kids with school, they basically work with their whole life. They have the whole family become involved, and they have a ton of different services that they help provide to those folks. And they've shown like super concrete results. They've really like, people do like 50% better in schools in reading competency and math competency. They do really well. And the longer they stay with Northside Achievement Zone, the better they do. So they're getting great results, and Minneapolis needs that kind of stuff right now. Equal Justice Initiative is trying to work against mass incarceration and sort of unlawful punishment and trying to end the death penalty. They're doing really great work. Like Katie said, Just Mercy is the book written by Bryan Stevenson, who is like such an amazing man. If you haven't heard Bryan Stevenson talk, you need to do it. Do yourself a favor. He's really an amazing
person. Do yourself a favor and have a cry.
That's right, have a cry. But his book is called Just Mercy, and you got a movie out called Just Mercy. Katie just mentioned that's on Amazon Prime right now, and they're streaming it for free, so check it out, y'all. So now we're going to do a little music, and we're just going to try this variation a whole bunch. It's called The Slap.
The Smack.
The Smack.
We're already
It's live, y'all.
Issue.
It's live.
Yeah, I just...
We're beyond names, you guys. Here we go, move it. Wander.
Beyond category, and have you heard what I've done?
I'm having
the
fun.
The word, just the one.
Can't speak for anyone else, but...
That takes the place of one I used to call baby doll. It ain't new, it ain't old, but if you do,
right,
as you're told.
Nice.
You'll find the letter if you take a look in Mr. Webster's dictionary book. The name is Sugar. I call my baby my sugar.
Which is sad because anyone who wanders into this live stream right now is going to wonder what the heck we're doing.
It's because all confusing. We'll call that good, everybody.
Okay.
So, Naomi, we got to get some more stuff. So, what I would like to do is I would like to take it all the way up to where we got it, and then we'll continue on. So can we show what we did without teaching it again?
Yes, the 4/8.
Yep.
Got it.
So we started out with this. We have a swing out.
Hey.
Go, Naomi.
Followers, if you want.
Texas Tommy optional, but you gotta get hand to hand right here. Five, six, we'll link it up. Hey, ho, hey, ho. And we'll call that arm's length walking around. I don't have any names for that, sorry. We're bad with the names.
We should call it something about link. Like Breath of the Wild or something. Except it's not that cool.
Next live stream will have some good names for you.
I'm sure there's some people watching the live stream who are like thinking about the different Breath
don't
of the Wild
Don't mention
references.
Breath of the Wild or they're all gonna quit the live stream and go play. Okay, so we are gonna link arms here. So in this moment, after this turn, we've got
one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
In this moment, I need Naomi to actually step forward. So I need to actually bring my elbow back just a tiny bit just to keep things going. Once we get that, we don't need to do a lot of this every time. You guys might recognize this from your old rockabilly days. You don't need to do that.
I really hope we sound tested for my really big laugh.
Yeah, I'm making sound.
Everyone's ears are being blown out right now.
Everyone loves your laugh. It's great. So when we're here, we're really just going to be going around, and this is pretty chill. It's not doing a ton.
Yeah, back touch optional.
Yeah, it's not doing a lot. But the first one, I do need to make sure Naomi comes forward. And this is still a little bit lead and follow right now. We haven't got into the sort of choreography part of it.
Yep.
So what I'd like to do, we'll show it. We're going to go into the arm link, and then we're going to go around for 8 counts. And I would like you to come with us right after. Watch what it is.
1, 2, 3, 5, 6,
connect
seven,
up.
And
hey, ho, hey, ho. Just that much. See how far you get around. Try it with us, everybody. All three people with actual partners in your lives.
From here?
From here.
Just the last move into the yo-ho-ho.
5, 6, 7, 8. Hey. Ho. Link up. And go, go, go. Hey. We did it.
Did you touch your partner's back? I was really tempted to.
Let's do it again.
Okay, same thing. Again, shake hands with your partner. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. D. Do ba ba do da hey.
You gotta be careful about that back touch. You know, two means turn, so you gotta be careful with that. You do it wrong, it won't work.
Let's go from the top.
Okay, no, let's
once?
Do this.
No?
I think actually it would be easier for now, just in this moment, to connect this to the next thing. So we're gonna do it.
Okay.
Like because where we are, I want leaders to have a bite-sized amount to think of. So
you know what occurred to me is it's not just Americans that are watching, so we should talk more slower.
You talk slower. Okay. All right, cool. So we're going to do the same thing one more time, but we're going to show you where we'll come out of it. We will come out of it with sort of a lead and follow thing that you can do on the social dance floor in, I don't know, 2024, whatever. Ooh. And then, sometime soon, hopefully.
What a downer.
No, but you can do this on the social
Strum.
Floor. And then we're going to do a choreography version of it. So when we have this here, we've got ba, 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 hey, ha, ha, around, 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 around. We got tuck, turn, turn, hey, rock, step, and we're just dancing together. So on that one, we've gone around a whole bunch. Mm-hmm. We've just gone single, 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 single for an 8 count. You should be about here. When I'm here, what I do is when I step with my left foot and I'm stepping with the right, that's the tuck of a tuck turn. I let things kind of slide out to this position. I get to the hand, yeah? And from there, a slow turn, I basically think to myself, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's like the end of an 8 count step, although it won't be the end of the 8 count in the music, that's no big deal. But if you can imagine that tuck, 5, 6, 7, 8, that's where we are. Watch it and see if you can kind of get that timing and footwork with us in your mind, and then we'll do it together. So, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You got 1 step, 2, 3. Here comes the tuck.
Tuck.
Step,
turn,
step,
turn.
Hey, rock. And I kind of sneak over and slide to it. Once again, if it's going to be social dancing, I got to really go.
Absolutely.
She does not know the plan.
That last bit can be a slide or a triple step. They're equivalent.
Absolutely. So why don't we try it together nice and slowly, because this one's a little sneaky. And just remember, leaders, when you're linked up here, you got to let that hand slide so you get the hands, not arm linked for that tuck. That'll be on the next one. So here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. Hey. Ha. Link arms. We go. 1, 2, 3, 5. Here comes the tuck. Now, tuck. 5, 6. Hey. Rock step. And again, I should stop saying 5, 6 because it's not actually that in the music.
You can just quietly say it to yourself.
I'll go step, step, triple step.
5, 6, 5, 6.
One more time. 5, 6, 7, 8. Hey. Ha. Who. Link arms. We go. Hey. Here comes the tuck, and bam, step, step, boom, rock, step. So that's a fun little thing we can try. Why don't we try it with a little medium music from the top? Okay. That crazy talk?
No, it's not crazy talk.
Let's link it from the top, everybody. You're gonna try it with us. We'll put on a little song, and then we'll kind of move away from this choreography part, into this choreography part we have next. We got some cool Frankie stuff to show you. It's going to be classic.
Do we want a little faster than what we were doing?
Let's go one tiny bit faster, but not much. Not full tempo yet.
Not full tempo. Got it.
Now we play the perfect tempo. Thank you. In advance.
Everybody, start with two swing outs and two Texas. Five, six, seven, eight.
Texas Tommy, if you wish, or just change hands. Here's the move. Let's link arms. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here comes the top. Hey, ba, ba, hoo, I like to slide it. And you dance it. Should we wait? We'll wait for the phrase.
Let's wait for the phrase. While we wait for the phrase. Brian Stevenson was your commencement speaker. That's awesome.
Woo!
Five, six, seven, eight.
Swingoo! Ah. Ah, what? We're busy!
Our doorbell just rang. I don't know if you could hear it because we got the mics on.
We got a package.
We could have the Amazon guy come in and learn some dance moves. You know, when you first started out swing dancing, you're like, if they just knew about swing dancing, they would love it. Maybe that Amazon guy started out swing dancing.
What did you say? One more time. Here we go.
Five, six, seven, eight.
Everybody, we're going to move on a little bit, and we're going to take that last step, and we're going to turn it into a bit of choreography, and we're going to do a little sequence that Frankie used to do all the time. Actually, we saw this because Naomi's been finding some old clips and thinking if they're worth sharing with the world. She's putting them on our new YouTube channel, so you should check it out. That's our outside door. Okay. You should check it out. There's a clip of Frankie dancing with Hannah, and he does some of these great little routines, and Frankie used to teach a lot of routines back in the day.
Sorry.
And a lot of people, I think, back around when it was easy to take Frankie for granted, would be like, we're not really leading or following this part. Why would we even do it? Because Frankie was teaching people to dance, not just lead and follow, to actually dance. And there's a satisfaction to it. You will see, we did it ourselves and we're like, this is so fun, we got to teach it. So we'll show that to you soon. We got to get there though. So when we are here, linked up, shabam, we go around.
We're about to do the tuck.
Oh, one, two, three, five, six, seven, we do.
Tuck. Boom.
Step, step, catch, bam. We're gonna jump it out. In a lead and follow situation, I could be like here, and she'd be like, what? And I'd be like, hey, and she would be less like hey than me.
I might not jump out, but I'd be like, something's happening.
But for now, we can both hit that jump. So we're gonna go down on five, land on seven. So let's go from just the tuck, like you're imagining. So if we're here,
sure.
Watch us one time. We'll go, well, there's no rock step on this one. We will go tuck,
one,
step,
three,
step,
four,
down,
five,
wham. Cool. Try it with us, everybody. They said cool. I heard them.
Everyone, link arms are going to go from the tuck.
Five, six, seven, eight.
One,
boom.
Three, five, four. Five. Catch.
Bam. And what we're looking for is to get the hip bone, not just like a kidney or a pelvic area. We just want a hip bone.
Don't keep showing them.
You want a firm part of the body there to get. So make sure you know where that is on your partner, and that's what you're going for.
It's all firm.
Lower when you think.
All okay. Right.
One more time. One more time. Together with us. Five. Six.
Here we go. Five, six, tuck it.
Ooh, I almost forgot.
Three. Hey.
Wham.
You almost went around.
I really missed it. The nice thing is they're probably doing this with people they know pretty well, so it can't be that terrible of a mess up when it gets uncomfortable.
Got it.
So when we land, we're going slow in that landing, and then we're going to hit a twist around. Is that correct?
Yeah. You want to do that?
Let's show it.
You know what? Let's do that. And I know we're sort of zipping ahead into this choreography. We're going to take questions again one more time really soon. So if you feel a little lost, it's no problem. We're just going to burn through some more stuff so we make sure we get through all 8 eights by the end of the hour.
And the next 2 8 counts are not that tough, honestly. So when we are here, we have landed. This is seven. Bam. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Did you get that? I'm doing Susie Q's. So I'm going to land 7, 8. And I'm going to actually start with the open step. Open, close, open, close, open, close.
On the 1.
On the 1.
Got it. And I'm just doing a normal twist around. I end up back where I started, but we got 2 8s to get around.
So leaders, you're basically going to take the fall around for 1, and then you say, hey, over my head while you face front for 2.
So you always get to face the computer screen.
Absolutely.
Cool.
I think we should all try that together because it's super easy. Let's land on 7 if you can. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 3, 5, 7, and 1, 3, 5, 7. Super good. We nailed it, Naomi.
One more time.
I think so.
5, 6, same thing. 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Over the head. 1. Hustle follows. Back to where you started from.
Cool. Let's do this. Why don't we connect those dots?
Yeah, before we take our break, we should just try it all.
We'll go back to the tuck. We'll turn, shoot out, and do it. Watch us one time. I'm here. There's no rock step at this point because we were walking. We
watch
go.
Watch us.
Tuck, step, step, down, land. Ha, 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 ho, ha, ho, ha.
Look at those eyes.
So good.
All right, let's try it from the tuck, everybody. So link arms with your partner.
We'll go one bit slower than we did
before. Absolutely.
Naomi's going to count you because I'll blow it.
Peter gets excited. He counts very fast. From the tuck, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and tuck. Turn, catch the hip, jump out, and twist, 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 go around the head. 5, 6, 7, 8. Same thing again. Link arms with your partner. 5, 6, 5 from the tuck and tuck. Turn, catch the hip, jump out, and hip, hop, 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 and around.
Nice.
We should take questions.
We should do, I think we just like, no?
We should take
questions. Question time, that sounds good. All right, everybody.
We should take questions.
We'll take a brief pause and wait till I put this up so we can see those questions. Got 3 minutes to ask some questions. We'll take a little chill. We're gonna get some water. Instagram, you can listen to us.
Breathe and drink.
Make sure you turn off your mic.
I did.
I hear music, mighty fine music. The murmur of the morning breeze up there. The rattle of the milkman on the stair. Sure, that's music, mighty fine music. The singing of the sparrow in the sky. The perking of the coffee right nearby. This my favorite melody. You my angel.
That's the question.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
No.
Let me try that again. Hi, everybody. If you're checking out the live stream, we've got a little thing about patreon.com/PeterandNaomi. That's our own site where we have instructional videos, as well as music playlists, a dance inspiration blog, and we also do live classes. So if you guys are having a good time and you want to join us for some more live classes, we do them for our patrons. There's a live solo jazz class coming up next week.
It's really weird that we used to be swing dance teachers, and now we're people who videotape swing dancing and sometimes do it live, sometimes do it.
I feel like we used to be swing dance teachers, and now we're people who professionally watch YouTube tutorials on how to
live stream. That's right. We're figuring it out. Well, thanks you guys for joining us. There are only a few questions there, and we'll get into those here. What I saw was someone was asking about hip catches in general and how to do those and make those sort of comfortable. It is a slightly more intimate thing than this.
That's a good question. And Peter, you're good at it, not being creepy, you know?
Yeah, I think, of course, like, intent is actually a huge, huge thing. So if you do something in a creepy way, it feels a lot creepier. Of course, there's a mistaken sort of sense of how things go between two people. It's not always interpreted the right way. So that's important to cover. What I find is that if I'm going to do some sort of hip catch, the number one thing I need to do is I need to make sure I'm actually kind of getting hip bone. Mm. And what I find is leaders often, when they're connecting with another person, they often aim a little high. And when you aim a little high, you're getting to a part that doesn't have bone behind it. It's a little softer, so it feels squishy and not as comfortable.
That's totally true. I would just assume, from our vast experience of teaching people anything from the hip, they always go for the waist. Leaders just assume that you're actually going for the waist, and ask your partner. Yeah. If you're trying it with a person, just say, like, is this your hip bone, or can you move my hand to where your hip bone is? And they'll usually go, it's here.
Yeah, we found that's the most helpful thing to do in class, is you're here, and then be like, now leaders, followers, put it where it actually is, and then, you know, just so you know, you can just ask. So if you have someone to practice with, that can be very helpful. The other thing is that in that moment, whenever you're doing a hip catch, mm-hmm. it can't stay there for too long or it gets weird. And it needs to be really soft and comfy. So even when it's firm, when it's here, I've got the heel of my hand like this, and I got a lot of contact, and I don't do a big shove. I'm more like absorb, and I go, there you go, but I'm not doing a big shove. You can't do a lot with it. And the other thing is, if you're doing a hip catch from behind, something like this, you can't curl the fingers. Oh, it's so sad. It squeezes out a single, an angel loses its wings every time a leader does this on a hip. It's so gross. So you gotta keep things soft and comfortable. So sort of a firm hold, but not a squeezy one. You can't get your fingers involved. It just feels really uncomfortable. Right, Naomi?
Right.
So in general, that's the deal. And I would say, leaders, when you're trying moves that are in different areas of connection than sort of the normal, you gotta be double good at them. Hmm. You just do. Yeah, so don't try that new stuff on someone you don't know very well. So. I didn't see a lot of other questions on this, so I think right now we're doing okay. I think we should move into the Frankie stuff.
Yeah. If you guys want to take a look at what inspired us on our YouTube channel.
Yeah, if you want to see someone do it way better, you can watch Frankie do this.
YouTube.com/PeterandNaomi. We've been putting up some old clips that aren't online for our dance inspiration blog on Patreon, and also some original dancing by us. And one of the clips we put up was Frankie Manning, you might have heard of him, and Hannah Lundmark. And they are teaching in harangue some really classic steps. And we were noticing it was slightly different than how we've taught the tuck and hook before. Mm-hmm. We liked some of the rhythms they did. They went into a different thing that we've seen Frankie do with Norma. So we started doing it as just practice, a way to warm up. And we were like, well, this is more fun than anything we think of. So we decided to add it to the end of our A-Days.
I just want to say, like, if we're raising money for the Northside Achievement Zone and Equal Justice Initiative, this is so much about trying to raise up Black Americans and help in a way that I feel, quite frankly, like I personally haven't for a long time. I've thought the right things. I've done some stuff. I'm generally nice. It's not enough. And I think so many people are realizing that right now, that being sort of generally a not racist cat is not enough. Mm. And so we want to do more. And let's, like, we can show Frankie, who gave so much to this dance and so generously gave it to so many people. Displaying his stuff makes sense. I've said before, we always say during Black History Month that if you love Black History, I'm sorry, if you love Lindy Hop, you love Black History. And I realize it's just not enough, you guys, because if you love Lindy Hop, you love Black history, which means you love Black culture, which means you love Black lives, which means you love Black people. You just got, that is what it is, with or without you believing it, it's the fucking truth. So if you love Lindy Hop, all this stuff goes along with it. So a little taste of somebody who really helped to create and innovate this dance just makes sense on a day like today. Mm. So we're gonna do this one here. Ba boom.
Yep.
Yeah? Why don't we just try it with no preamble from there? Five, sure. Six, seven. Ha.
Shoot.
Oh, it feels so good, you guys, when Naomi's the one that messes up. It happens so infrequently, and it really balances out the scales. Let's try it again.
All right.
For Naomi.
I don't think I'm going to do it any better, but let's try it again.
You are. Five, six, seven, eight, one, three, four, five, six. Hey. That's okay. No, we'll go to the next thing.
I was excited.
We'll go bite size. So this is kind of like the Big Apple stuff. We go.
Why don't we turn around? So
yeah.
We can follow along.
And you know what? This has a name. Frankie called it leapfrog.
We found out from the clip.
Is it a hopfrog? Leapfrog.
Leapfrog. Because you were like, he calls this leapfrog?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which I didn't know. So it goes on 8 with the butt slap.
Maybe. Without turning?
Sure. Just showing. For us, we'll just show you 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 3, 4, off the bam. And that bam, you're just going to stick it out. Watch it one more time. And why don't we go this way? Because I'm going to kick you.
But we're on that side.
Nevertheless, 5, 6.
5.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. See how we don't kick each other? And then we'll do it in turning soon.
I get it.
One time with us, everybody. Try that much. It's slapping your butt on 8. We'll go really slowly. And we haven't counted out a bunch. Try and get the sounds in your head. You don't need numbers just yet. 5, 6, 7. Ha!
Jump. Together, fall off the boom.
And when you're doing that last boom, you're really just sticking the foot down. It's a little like the slap that Naomi's doing.
Oh, I think it's different for me. I step on it.
Oh, that's true.
Because they do the thing where they're on different feet and then they're on the same feet.
It's choreography. Good catch, Naomi.
Good catch now instead of later. So followers,
so
when we're doing this,
building a treatise about the wrong thing.
Check it out. Oh, I fall off the step on it. We're going to put our weight on it. Leaders are not.
I'm not. Boom, boom, fall off the slap.
All right, here we go.
Five, six, five, six, seven.
One more time. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. And jump together, fall off the.
So now, let's you and I face this way, and we're gonna turn with it. I want you to watch how we turn. We do a little 180. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. 3, 4, 5, 6, bam, we find each other. Yeah?
So I'm turning away from my partner, I'm turning to my left, you're turning to your right.
That is correct. I didn't know until you said it. 5, 6.
Are we showing it or are they doing it?
That's a great question. Let's all do it together to the extent that you are able. And okay. If you can't do it yet, don't worry, we'll get a bunch of reps.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and hey, ho, fall off the boom. 5.
You keep going, I want to see if they hold. I get it.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Hey,
ha, oh, ah, oh. Someone asked me if they could take some video clips. You can, although I think this will be up on YouTube for a little while anyway. So
we're gonna put it up on YouTube. It's gonna be up on Instagram. I think on Facebook too. We're just gonna leave it up so that people can keep donating to these great organizations.
Yeah. So if you want to take a clip, that's fine. But I think you'll have access to all of it. Look at all these people. I saw Shahan out there.
Oh, dude, let's do some shout-outs.
What's up? Oh, Terry.
Hi, Sarah.
What's up?
Oh my gosh.
Okay,
that is
cool.
So sweet. Okay.
Okay, cool. So I wish there was a video chat, but we are barely complicated enough to do this. So we're going to do this together. And when we do it, we just got to turn around and face each other. Let's try just a couple more times. You try with us. We're here from the butt slap. This is leapfrog. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Ha, ho.
Hey.
Do you want to?
Yeah.
I feel like we're ready.
Yep.
Feel like we're ready. It's an old song. So when we do this, we come around. Let's show what we do. We're going to add knee slaps.
Got it.
And actually, Frankie called it thigh slaps.
You're blowing my mind.
I know.
Here's the thing. You know, you see those clips online all the time, and then you don't watch them. And then you watch them for 2 seconds, and then you're like, oh, he explained everything and said the name for it.
I think a big part of us, like, honoring the history of this dance is to actually get it right. And you'd be amazed how often dance steps get watered down and rhythm just goes out and out. And by the time you get to it, it's way less rhythmic and way less interesting. And when you look at what it used to be, when the people who did it back in the day, it's way more interesting, way more idiosyncratic. And so little things like this, just like, oh, he slapped his thigh, not his knee.
That
makes some
sense.
Kind of different. Yeah.
I'm not knee slapping. Why do I call knee slaps?
Well, it's a thigh slap. Check out the clip. It's really worthwhile. For now, stay with us. Don't leave yet. We're going to try it. Watch what we do one time. 5, 6. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hey, 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 huh. It's really fun.
So we're both slapping our left thigh.
Uh-huh.
That's why, followers, you gotta shift onto your foot.
Yep, that's why you slap, leader, so you can lift that one up. You slap on the even beats. Usually when you make those noises, it's gonna be the even beat, because it's cooler.
Let's do it.
1, 3, 5, 7, you get it. Here
I
we go.
I can just see certain people like making a compilation of certain moments. This is like a dare.
We can
to
just
Maddie
hope
Maddie's
not watching.
All right.
Here we go. 5 with us. Here we go. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Hey, ho! 5, 6, 7.
Slap your knee. I mean your thigh. Oy, here we go. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and hey, ho, hey, ho, slap, ha, 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 ho.
Ooh, it feels good.
I'm really slapping.
Me too. It's worth it.
Okay.
Why don't we take it from the twist around? Because there's just a sneaky little transition that we have to get to that butt slap. We got to let go just in time.
You're not wrong, and we only have about 8 minutes.
Yeah. So watch this one time. If we're twisting around, we've landed on 7, 5, 6, 7. 1, 3, 5, 7.
Around to the front. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Hey, hey, hey. Ah, feels good fast. We might have to slow down for the stuff before it, but we'll see how we do. Just know, everybody, when you're coming around in that twist around, you're kind of gonna wanna kind of get ready on 7 to do your 8. So watch us one more time when we're here.
You want to just show that transition slowly?
Sure. So you're coming around like this.
Yeah.
So we're going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1.
So I don't take 7, 8. I just step on 7 and go for the butt slap.
So we do a twist around on the end of that second one. On 7, you get ready for your butt slap and you let go. It's just choreography time.
Okay.
Connect up, everybody. We're going to do the twist. Land on 7 if you can to get used to the transition. 5, 6.
Here we go.
5, 6, 7.
Twist around.
Ha, ha, ha. Ha.
Back to where you started, ha. Followers.
5, 6, 7, 8, 1.
Ha!
5, 6, 7. Ha! Ha! Ha!
Again.
I'm waiting on you.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and a 1. Hey!
Ha!
Ah. Go around. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. Hey! Slap your thigh. Ah.
That feels good.
Let's do it one more time and we'll show the ending. So okay. Everybody try it with us and we'll just go on a little bit more. There's only 2 8s left.
Here we go.
5, 6.
Down on 7.
5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hey, ho! Slap your thigh. Ah! Hey, oh, hey, oh, oh, oh.
Exit.
Oh.
Stage left.
We haven't left you.
We're back! So the last little bit is super easy and really fun. So we have gone here. We go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 2, 3, 5, 7. You walk off just cool.
So here's the thing, followers. We've been slapping this thigh. I step onto that foot so I can go back with my right. Leaders, you're not doing a step.
I go, ba ba boom. And just come into my...
No, I mean from the thigh slap, you're using the same foot.
You're so right. 5, 6, 7, 8. You're so right. I was in the wrong part. Now I'm with you. Time machine. Naomi, what were you saying?
I was saying the transition's a little different from the thigh slap. I step on it so that I can go back on my right foot. I'm not just touching it and using the same foot.
And leaders don't.
Let's show that.
Sure. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I step, hey, ho, hey, ho.
Why don't we do that much to the snap?
Just to the snap. And followers, I'll just warn you, it's a simple snap, but it's going to feel weird because you're used to doing the mini dip with the other leg up. So just know that it'll feel a little funny because you have your left leg up.
Sorry. Sorry, we did it. Here
That's
we go, everybody. 5.
From
six,
where?
From the thigh slaps.
Got it.
5, 6. 5, 6, 7.
8, 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 6, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8
take it down. Kind of cool. So look down for it. Here we go. 5, 6, same thing. 6, 7. Ha. Ah. Ah. Hey. Hup. Hey. Ooh. Ha. So let's pretend we're there. I think you're with us. What we're going to do is we're just going to hold it for one count. Ah, ah, and we come out of it. So the timing will be 5, 6, 7, 8. 1.
Step and 2. Off, step.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. She's going to do kind of a cool little fishtail back. And I'm going to do like a pimp walk, basically. That's what they used to call it. It's a pimp walk. You just like walk kind of cool. You can do it however you want. I keep it simple.
There's no particular style. Let's refer everyone to the clip once again.
What's exactly? This is what my life. Peter's going to keep it simple and Frankie's going to do it really cool. All okay. Right. So we'll do this all the way through. You watch us.
Sure.
And then I think you can catch it if you can get that dismount. The main thing on the dismount, we should just say, because I know it's a little tricky sometimes. When you hit that 8, you hold one beat and you don't just randomly drop your feet down. If you go 8, 1, and 2, if there's a little breath into that. So watch me again. eight, one, and two. It's way easier than if you just think feet. Eight, one, and two. You're not ready to do the next thing. So you kind of get back into the little swing and bounce of the dance. One little half beat before your feet hit the ground.
It's not mandatory, but it does help.
It helps. So we're gonna go from it. Five slaps. Five, six, seven, hey, 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 and shin, shin, shin,
shin, ha, stop. Hey, ho, hey, ho, hey, ho.
Every time we exit, we like to leap. Woo! And I'm back. All right, everybody. Make sure you exit all the way out of your screen now. All right, you gotta get all the way off screen. Okay, here we go. We're gonna try that same thing we just did. From the thigh slaps, go with us. Five, six, five, six, seven, hey.
One, two, three, four, five. Hey. Step on it, hey. Five, six, seven, eight. Step off, ha, 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 ha.
Did you do it? Let's try it again. Same thing.
Just be sitting in our living room like, ha, ha.
I can just see people like, yeah, I got it. Okay, here we go, one more time.
It's just an ice cream cigarette.
We will sweat for your benefit, no problem. Five, six, five, six, seven, slap the thigh.
Shake it.
Ha, ho, ha, ho, ha, ho, ha, ho, ha, and we did it.
Strummy, we only got a couple minutes left.
That's cool, what we need to do is back this thing up. So, I think we should go from the tuck one time. Is that cool, from right here? Yeah. And we just show this transition. So when we're here, remember, there's no rock step. We've been walking around. We go tuck, step, step.
Catch the hip.
Bam, now, boom. Now, this stuff you know. Ha, ha, ho, ha, ha, ho. Ha, ha, oh, now we're home free.
Shake it. Let's do it to music.
Try it with us, everybody. Get it close. Here's the great thing. You can mess it up as bad as you want. Nobody will know.
Your partner will know.
Well, just your partner, and you guys can fight about it later. That's fine. You live together. It's cool.
You can text each other about it.
That's right. All good. We got Shahan up off the couch. That's good.
Hey.
Now, leapfrog's a jam, man.
What time is it, Shahan?
We don't even want to know.
Okay.
Sure.
We're going from?
We're going from the tuck one time.
Okay.
So what, we have our arms already linked. Just that much.
Got it.
No rock step.
Five,
six, five, six, seven,
you
eight,
want little girl,
five, five, hit,
that is
twist,
me, not her.
Ha, 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 ha.
You
and
want
around.
Little girl, that is me, not
hey.
Her. But I like a man that takes me in my world. I shouldn't even bother with your type.
All right.
I slowed it down a little bit for practice purposes, but maybe I shouldn't have.
No, you know what? Let's take it from the top, top one time, because I think that's what people need. And let's keep it at that tempo. Yeah. So when we do it this time, remember, it's two swing outs. Then you got to Texas Tommy or change hands. And then we get that fancy little turn and we go around for a little 8-8 count. So can you and I show that with no music?
We should just do it. We don't have any time.
Who cares?
Okay.
Someone going to kick us out of the venue?
The next teachers need the space.
Someone's been teaching under a circuit for a while. Like, Steve and Rebecca are going to be angry. We're not done soon enough. Like, oh, we're fine. Like, I think we have the venue.
Are Steve and Rebecca watching?
It would be awesome.
They're so punctual. Okay.
Let's you and I do it from the top. Why don't we do it without music just so everyone can really see it? Am I crazy?
Music makes everything better.
You are correct. Why would I disagree with that? Watch us, everybody.
This music makes everything better.
I think so. Swing it out. Okay.
You want little girl that is seen, not her. You want little girl that is seen,
here's
not
her. Here's the
turn.
Hit it soft.
But
walk,
I like a
walk,
man that
walk.
Takes
here's
me
the
at
top.
My word.
Hey, get the hip. Twist it.
I shouldn't ha. Even bother with your type.
Ho.
I
ho.
Shouldn't even bother with your type. Such a pretty tiger change his stripes. You want little girl thinks
all right, everybody.
Man gives it all
you're gonna try that with us.
You want little girl
we're gonna go from the top. Get it close.
It's heavy. It's a real speed. Here we go.
It's up.
Five, six.
Five, six, seven.
You want little girl that is seen, not heard.
It's
but I like a man that takes me at my word.
I got excited, you guys.
Oh, Maddie. I shouldn't even bother with your time.
How can such a pretty package change it? It's good.
No one saw it.
No one noticed, I'm sure.
No one can rewind it.
Well, we're not recording. Oh, wait, we are.
All right.
Hey, maybe some of you guys messed it up and you want to do it one more time. That's totally fine. I don't really understand that kind of thing, but if you did mess it up, sure, we can try it again, no problem.
You're so understanding.
I am so understanding.
Also, that was pretty peppy. Should I slow down a little bit for everyone to practice?
We're gonna look real quick. I don't think so. We're gonna just do it. I'm looking real quick.
Was that too fast to watch your computer or phone screen? Just kidding.
I think we're good.
All right.
One more time, y'all, and then we take
full
a quick break.
Full speed.
And then as you can see, we get into the solo jazz up next.
So proud of himself. Here we go.
Overlays. Last time around, everybody, make it count.
Here we go.
Don't mess up, who cares?
You want a little girl that is seen, not her. You want a little girl that is seen, not her. But I like a man that takes me at my word. I shouldn't even bother with your type.
That's it, everybody. Give yourselves a big virtual hand. You did it. Or you didn't. You just watch. Go play Zelda. Or don't.
Or don't, because we have another class coming up.
That's right, y'all.
All right, listen to our heavy breathing. I think we're going to take a 3-minute class break.
At least 3 minutes.
We'll take a look at the chats. We'll say hi to Instagram.
Thanks, you guys.
And we'll come back with Solo Jazz.
All right, this one. Mike, Naomi. Hello, everybody. We're back. Solo jazz time. We're doing it. So, Naomi, is your microphone on?
It is on.
Okay.
I'm just setting up the Instagram right now.
Okay, we're getting that Instagram all set and ready. So I hope you guys had a good time. Once again, remember, we are donating.
Where is it? Right now.
Donating to Equal Justice Initiative and to Northside Achievement Zone. If you don't know what they are, we got some information pinned up there. But Equal Justice Initiative seeks to end mass incarceration. They are an amazing organization. There's a book about them. There's a movie about them, both called Just Mercy. You should check them out. Check out Brian Stevenson. If you can hear this person speak, he's someone who will change the way you think about things and probably get you to commit yourself to more action. I really think he's a profound person. And we've been donating every year at Uptown Swingout. We run a Luck of the Draw competition, and it's $5 for everyone to enter. And all of that money goes to Equal Justice Initiative. We raised, I think, $500-$600 each year and sent it to them. It's been really awesome. So we're doing donations to them. Half of the money we get from you guys will go to them. The other half will go to the Northside Achievement Zone. That's a local organization that's on the north side of Minneapolis, which is where basically most of the African-American people were pushed to live via redlining and about a bunch of discriminatory housing practices for many, many years. And so there's lots of trouble. It's cut off from the rest of the city and stuff. And the Northside Achievement Zone is seeking to end generational poverty and really get people up out of these bad cycles. So they take kids and they work with them in school, but they work with the entire family, and they have a bunch of different services that work together to try to help impact these kids' lives, and they stick with them for years and years and move on and really help them achieve. So they're doing great work, and they're doing it right here in Minneapolis. And I think, as we all know right now, Minneapolis needs that help. So that's the other 50% of the money will go to Northside Achievement Zone.
Yeah, make sure you do the PayPal or Venmo. If you can put workshop in the notes, that's great. If not, I'll just assume you meant for that money to go to these great organizations, and we'll make sure they get to them. We'll make a big announcement about how much we earn.
Yeah, and of course, if you want to donate just on your own, go ahead. Like, we're happy to do it.
Doesn't have to be through us.
So for now, we'll get 1 hour of solo jazz coming up. So that's, I hope you're ready. This should be more people at this point. You should officially be up off the couch because you got no excuse. You have yourself.
They can watch on the couch.
You can watch on the couch and I don't care. Give money. All right. So Naomi made this thing up. She's going to do a little bit more of it. I'll be along for the ride, trying to do my best and not mess up.
Sounds good. We're going to start with a lock turn. So actually, having you here is great. Maybe you can show it forward or backwards and I can show it the other way.
Whichever way you wish.
Why don't you show it backwards?
You got it.
So simple lock turn. We're going to sweep the right leg. Oh, and Instagram, I should let you know, if we get out of the frame a little bit, we've got a horizontal video on both Facebook Live and YouTube Live right now.
That's right.
All right, here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. Sweep, rock step, turn around. So in order to do that, we're going to sweep our right leg across, rock, we cross, and then we come all the way around. And a way to make that easy is to really jump through that cross and turn. So watch, I go sweep, rock step, I jump up, down. If I try to just twist and then unwind, I end up twisted on the other side. So let's show it again.
Yep, you mean.
5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Let's have you guys try it. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 3, 5, 7. I think it makes a nice effect if when we cross our legs, we keep our upper body facing forward. It gives us a little torque, and it makes it look like we're not going halfway.
It's called a lock turn, so you want to get that lock action before you go, as opposed to being like, you didn't lock anything. You want to get that lock there. That's the idea.
Let's try it again. Keep your upper body facing forward till the very end. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 3, 5, 7. So from here, we've landed in this nice soft 7. We're going to do double kick, single, single. So we start with the right leg.
And let's make sure they get used to doing those singles and landing on the correct foot.
Sounds good.
It'll help the transition. So can you and I just show that?
A couple ending times on 8? In a row or just that?
Just that.
Got it. 5, 6, you and me, double.
Do you want to show it now? Okay, we'll do it now. 5, 6, 7, 8, double. Single, single. Ending, landing on that right foot would really help.
Again, for you and me or for them?
Let's do everybody.
Okay, here we go. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, double. Single, single. You should end up on your right leg. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and double. Single, single.
What if we did that in the other leg just for practice?
Sure. Left leg, everybody. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and double. Single, single.
Now you'd end on your left.
Exactly.
Again.
5, 6, left leg, everybody, and double. Single, single. All right. If we land on the correct leg after this little pattern, we just put a box step in between.
So you do the whole chunk?
The whole thing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Just us. Watch us.
5, 6, 7, and double on the right. Box step. We double on the left. In box step. Dee-dee-dee-dee. Oh, yeah.
So we're going to do both? Okay, got it.
Sorry.
Ditching. Okay.
Well, when you said both.
That I just don't want.
Let's talk about it.
Let's
just kidding.
Let's not talk about it.
Okay.
So let's, I think we do one of those because they're not going to do both of them. I don't want to switch sides just yet. Let's just get through one.
All right.
Okay, so we will do both steps, which is the kicks and the box step. That's 2 8 counts. Yeah?
Here we go.
5 6 right step foot. Right. Here we go.
Double. Kick step, cross.
Left, right, left, right. One more time.
5 6 5 6 7 and right leg. Single, and left.
And it wouldn't be a Peter and Naomi class teaching Charleston if we didn't say, get your lazy butt off the floor on that Charleston. So when you're doing this, if you're like, hey, it's not that interesting. To be fair, in the Frankie clip, if you guys check it out, he's not jumping, but he's 91 when he's teaching. So shut up. So get that standing leg bouncing. It looks better.
You know, we should say who we took a class on that from.
Well, that was definitely Ryan showed that. Ryan Francois kind of broke that down for us. And he was basically like, when you bounce a lot up top, it doesn't look like much. And when you bounce a lot down low, even when you're more quiet up top, it's way more dynamic and energetic.
When you said he broke it down, I thought you were going to say broke our minds, spirits.
He did.
It was a mind-blowing class. So it really changed the way we do Charleston. And if you guys try it, it is more effort, but it really changes the way you do Charleston. I think it's better.
There's a payoff. Why don't we take it one more time thinking of that. On the right leg, 5 6 5 6 7 8, double, single, and left, right, left. If we're here, now we can do the whole thing on the left leg.
5 6 5 6, left leg, double, single, and cross.
Now you know. Why don't you try that left side with us?
All right, left side, 5 6 5 6 7, and double, bounce with it, and hey, ho, hey, ho. I think I can try both sides.
I think so.
I think I'm gonna sneeze.
Be fascinating. Right side first, everybody. Very cute. Are you on?
I am, now.
Here we go, 5 6, right side, here we go.
And double, single, hey. Left side, double, single, and hold. We're going fast.
Let's go slower and do the same thing.
5 6 5 6 7, and double, single, hey, ho, hey, ho. And dee, da, bee, da, ba, do, ba, da, boom, ba, bee, ba, ba, do.
Cool.
Should we take it from the top or should we push on?
I think we should take it from the top, just getting used to that intro.
So,
that
basically.
Catches the intro. Do you want to do it to the song so they can hear how that catches the intro, that lock turn?
Yeah. So I'm going to play a song by my band.
Hey-o.
Slightly Selfish, but also.
Also, no copyright match.
Exactly.
Because she took it off. So when we do this, just listen. We're going to, that kick and lock turn, that's going to catch the end of the intro. So I want you to watch us do it one time so you can see where to come in.
Intro's almost done. 5 6 7 8. I'm the world's most happy creature. Tell me, what can worry be? I'm crazy about my baby, yet my baby's crazy about me. Mr. Cupid was so our teacher,
but you know the rock turn starts on the intro. Agree. Let's try it to music.
You want to face away from them so they can do it with us?
Sure.
Here we go. Come in, Naomi.
Here we go. 5 6 7 8. I'm the world's most happy creature. Tell me, what can worry be? I'm crazy about my baby, and my baby's crazy about me. Mr.
Nice.
Cupid was our teacher.
That's right.
That's the reason we agree.
That's true.
All right, next part's pretty simple. Break down real quick. We're just going out and cross, then we paddle with that foot. So.
And why don't we practice the ending of the paddle every single time?
Sure.
That really makes a difference. And I think we can just show them both. We can link it to the other
side. I think the out and cross, you guys are gonna get just fine. For the paddle, I keep my weight over this left leg and just take my right leg, doing a little touch, paddling around. So think you're in a canoe with one oar. You're just staying in one spot.
I would just say, though, like, we don't want to actually have them powering with that.
But we don't want them doing this.
I know, but the canoe is this.
Oh, like, Maddie, are you taking this clip
this is
right now?
So sad right here. So
is anyone joining us
we
right
don't
now?
Want that one. We're actually pushing with this. You turn, and you kind of really more turn from the middle of you and tap that leg down. So it's not powered too much from that right leg.
Do it cool.
Yeah. Can you show how it links? And I want you guys to watch the seven as she paddles around. So from the top of that boat, all four of you come to that.
One, two, three, five, six, seven.
She goes one, two, three, five, six.
Seven.
Change.
One, two, three, five, six, seven.
So on the last one of the paddle around, you got to put your weight on that leg that's out there a paddling. Why don't we try it really slowly together?
All the way through?
All the way through.
Five, six, right foot we go. One, two, three, five, six, seven. Touch, touch, then step. One, two, three, five, six, seven. Touch, touch, then step.
Let's try it again.
Five, six, and right, and left, and right. Step on it, and left, and right, and left. Step on it. One more time. Five, six, and hey, and ho, and around. Step on it, hey, and ho, and around. Step.
Why are we going so insanely fast at the end? I think we're going faster and faster as we go. So, why don't we try that together? Do you want to add that on?
Do the whole thing?
I think so. And then we'll take a little break.
Great idea. Let's go from the top. We'll look in the chat.
Okay, cool.
With music?
Let's go from the top with music. It just makes so much sense with that intro.
All right. Who wrote that intro?
That's a good question. This is going to produce a lot of static electricity. That is true. Sorry, Luke.
Oh, are you on some carpet?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Why would a dancer have carpet?
You're just supposed to rip it up before class, dude.
Duh. Okay. This is a little slow down. I'm going to take it full speed. Here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm the world's most happy creature. Tell me, what can worry be? I'm crazy about my baby. Yes, my baby's crazy. Step out with your right.
Mr. Cupid was our teacher. That's the reason we agree. I'm crazy about my baby. Yeah, my little baby crazy about me.
Let's try one more time and then we'll check the chat.
Hold it in your hand.
Check how much static electricity you have.
That's right.
Nice and easy, everybody. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Who?
Sir.
I'm the world's most happy creature. Tell me what can worry be.
Out to the side.
Mr. Cupid was our teacher. That's the reason we agree.
Step.
I'm crazy about my baby. Yeah, my little baby, please about me. Pasta, get your book.
All right, everybody. You deserve a 3-minute water break, but don't go anywhere. Make sure you put your questions in the chat because we'd love to read them. Help you out with anything you need help on. And just say hi.
Water break.
It's an A1 conversation. We'll be right back.
everybody. We're coming back. I'm turning that down a little bit. Mm-hmm. So.
What's in the chat? Who can we say hi to?
Well, we got some people. Ozzy Vashti, what's up?
Alice, Jerry Foot's there. Doing with the baby? Hey.
Jerry.
Maddie's saying, where is Tora? Tora may make an appearance. She's at my parents right now. She may stop by at the end. If you come by, if you stay till the end, you might see the baby. That's the thing.
That's why we're forcing you to stay till the end. So Vashti, hi.
A couple people were asking about the kick, that little lockstep, which we'll go over one more time. I can't help your static electricity, sadly. And they're saying the third is either the second is either the first. Okay, cool. So let's do this. Let's go over that lockstep one more time. So I think one thing to think about when we're doing that, this is also called a Charleston break. Mm-hmm. When we do that, if you think about sweeping the leg kind of across your body and sweeping it around in this little circle, it's going to come back behind you very naturally for a rock step. So it's actually a pretty straight leg, and most Charleston kicks have this punching sort of feel, more like pumping, and this one doesn't. It's really kind of a sweep. Sweep it around, and it comes behind you. Another thing that we learned from Ryan, if you can, think about your hips twisting not only on that lock, but on the rock step. It looks more dynamic, and it gets things ready. It's harder, but it can really make it better. So if you go sweep, twist, boom, pop, it'll really help. So I think if you have any difficulty with that lockstep, you want to sweep that leg around, and that's going to come around in this path behind you, and you're going to jump the rockstep. So you're not going to go step, step. You're going to go jump, jump, kind of bouncing, sweep, bounce, 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 bounce. If you can get off the ground, all of this gets a lot easier to accomplish.
You want to turn around and let them try it with you?
Mm-hmm. Why don't we try it nice and slowly? 5, 6. 5, 6, 7. Yeah, sweep, bounce, 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 bounce. And now let's try to wind up our hips on that rock step and on that lock as well. Okay, here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. Sweep, bounce, 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 bounce. I didn't do a great wind up. One more time. 5, 6, 7, 8. Sweep, twist it. One more time with me. 5, 6. Sweep it around. 5, 6, 7, 8. Sweep, twist, bounce. Hope that helps a little bit. That's the main question I saw. I think the rest of it's pretty good for folks.
That's good.
So, fix my mic.
Should we, Peter Schramm, should we push on, or should we fancy up some of this stuff?
I think we should push on for a moment.
Okay, we're gonna get through all the material. We've got a whole chorus worth of solo jazz. We are already halfway through, which is great, but we know that there are lots of people watching. Some people are newer to solo jazz, some people are way more experienced, so we have some ways to fancy it up. We'll show that towards the end. You gotta stay to the end for the fancy things and for the baby.
That's right.
All right. So we just did a paddle around. Now we're gonna do boogie forwards.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Usually you do 4 of these forward and 4 of these back, but you probably don't have that much room in your apartment. So we're just gonna do 2 forward, 2 back. Try that with us.
I wanna show it to him one time like this.
Okay.
And just, can you say one thing about boogie forwards? I'll say one thing about boogie backs.
Sure.
Because we are supposed to be teaching.
Sure.
Shows up.
Do it. Do like this.
Do like
as
this.
The great Tina Morales Armstrong says, do like this. Okay, so one thing to think about with boogie forwards is a lot of people, when they're doing boogie forwards, they end up bringing their hips forward because they're thinking so much about making this moon shape. And I think it looks a lot better. And most of the old clips I see, they keep their hips back. So even though they are making this little moon shape going forward, they sit back with it instead of letting it go forward and having this angle to their body the whole time.
It looks cool when you do it.
Oh, thank you. So make sure you keep your butt back even as you're going forward.
Let's try 4 boogie forwards.
All right.
If you could fit it in your apartment.
So the right leg, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sit back, sit back, sit back, sit back. Let's try it again. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And one little thing I'll say, a lot of people learn this styling where they bring their arms up and to the side. I'm not crazy about it. I think it kind of brings us up and out of the rhythm. So can you guys just try keeping the arms chill down here? You can snap it. I tend to work my shoulders a little bit, just like I would with a Shorty George.
Yeah.
5, 6, keep your arms low. 8, 1, 3, 5, 7. Let's try it again. You can keep your arms even lower and kind of reach down. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Sit back, 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 back.
Cool. Right. On the boogie backs, all I would say is we're doing this rhythm. Clap, step, step, clap, step, step. So you're going down and down, down and down. There's a million ways to do that. But I would say if you're doing this classic one, kick, ball change, kick, ball change. Don't do it perfectly straight. You want to get down and turn to the side.
A little angle.
It's cooler.
You're so right.
Let's go two forward and two back.
Okay.
Two boogie forwards, two boogie backs. That's what people in the UK. Boogie back. Here we go. Five, six, the pattern. Five, six, seven,
eight. One. Five. Eight, one. Get that angle. I want to keep going.
Let's do that like 800 times in a row.
Okay.
Five, six, five, six, seven. Make it better each time.
Right?
Yeah, pretty good. I think they got it in.
We only do it for 2 8s, so two little sets in the routine.
And now we're going to do a break.
You're right.
A full break. If you guys haven't done a full break, here's a very simple version of it. It goes, you start on 8. Step, touch, walk, 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 walk.
I want to cut in for 1 second. We mentioned that, you know, being a scene that doesn't have a lot of connection with the original scene, a lot of things get watered down. This is one of those things where you might learn this on your first shim sham. It's not the actual break, it's like a training wheels break.
Exactly.
So if that's all you can get, that is super fine with us. We're swing dance teachers, we're here to help you. That's a great break to start out with. That's not the actual break from back in the day. So can you break down that one quickly, and then we'll get to the real
break.
Yeah,
we'll do training wheels real quick. So it goes 8, 1, 2, 3,
Step, five, six, seven.
So all it is a big old step. Step, touch, walk, 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 walk. Your last walk probably comes back forward.
Most of them probably have it because it is supposed to be intermediate advanced, but let's try it a couple times.
People always go to the right level, right? Nobody ever does the wrong level.
I was just
level.
Subtly mentioning
Jesus.
It.
Jesus, come on. They're in their living room. They can literally be anybody. Okay. So let's do that one time. The training wheels version.
Someone's going to say they like learned Lindy Hop from these two sad workshops today.
So horrifying.
Okay, here we go. Say sad. Five, they're great.
See, they're great. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If you do that, you're not a terrible person. You're getting there.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Step, touch, step, touch, step, 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 step.
Now let's show the real break.
Yes.
Just show it?
Yeah.
5, 6, 7. Ah. 1,000 times cooler, if we're honest. So, I'll say the thing that I think about it.
Please.
Like the thing I think about is when I do this, I like to get down into that 8, 8, 1, and I can bounce up off the 2. Once I get that first kind of bounce off my left foot, where I land on my left foot, then I'm doing the right sort of thing. Watch it. I go step, touch, bounce, and cross. That's how I think of it. Any other things you think about?
I would just say when you bounce, you're going to be really tempted to throw your head back and really bring your knees up. A lot of people think the bounce is about lifting their knees, but it's really not. Again, I keep my butt back. And you're just bouncing off the floor. You're not lifting your knees up.
If your head floats a little bit and your lower body bounces on, that's cool, but you don't need to get high on the bounce. Mm-hmm. If you do it high in the beginning, that's great for learning. That's great for learning, but you want You do it for the time, not for the height. The bounce is to keep the timing perfect, not for the height.
Let's try it.
Try it with us, everybody. Let's go real slowly.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7.
Step, touch,
bounce, and cross, out, in. Again.
Say a little mantra if you can, everybody.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Step, touch, bounce, and cross, out, in.
I'll stay cross on that one. Five.
One more time.
6, 5, 6, 7, step, touch, bounce, and cross, out, in.
Ooh, I went in. I got freaked out.
We did that in old routine. One more time with us, and I want you guys to like have at least this sound, and I want you to say the sound. Bop, boom, bop, boom, bop, boom, bop, ah, ah. I want you to get that accent. If you can hear the sound, it really works. And having learned from, I've taken a couple classes from people who actually danced at the Savoy back in the day, and their teaching is very different than most of the teaching you get, including ours. But one thing I really got for them is they said, here's the rhythm, now do it. And it was very much about hearing it and doing it and not just seeing it. When I got to sort of demonstrate in a class for Norma Miller, when she came to Uptown Swingout, we taught this, she showed this routine. It was like 2 choruses long, super fancy stuff, not exactly trickeration, but different stuff, really cool. And she was just yelling at us saying, you guys are just watching, you're just looking. And I thought it was so good because so often people don't even look in class when I'm teaching. But what she meant was you need to listen. You need to use your ears to listen and be dancers, not just students. So I think if you can think of a sound, bop, boom, bop, boom, bop, 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 if that sound is a little earworm for you, you're gonna get this step way sooner. So I'm gonna scat it with us this time. Five, six, five, six, seven, bop, 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 bop. One more time with the sound, you say it. I wanna hear it now. Five, six, seven, bop, 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 bop. I think it's pretty good.
Should we go back to the boogies, or should we just finish this bridge?
Because it's such a connection.
You know, we've only got
one
more eight left to the bridge, and it's really simple.
Ooh, my sweaty back keeps pulling this cord. It's driving me crazy.
Yeah.
Isn't it gross? I can't get it at all. Okay.
Well,
Naomi, fix me, fix me.
Can
fix me,
we worry
that.
About that later? Are you guys watching? Are you guys donating to great
like
causes
a
because of this?
No, this is behind the scenes material. This is extra bonus DVD.
This is behind the scenes. I'll say that.
It's a scene. All right.
Yum.
So when we're doing this, we're going to go into this thing right after.
Yep, yeah, we just step right left.
Mm-hmm. And what is the music there? We'll just figure it out. Five, six, and bop. Ah, 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 ah,
right, left.
It's a thing. That's it's going to hit some music.
I like it.
It's cute. So when we do it, eight, one, ha, ah, 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 right, left, and you take it around kind of sexy style.
We just start on that going to the back.
Yep, so you need right, left, on, that is next, 8-1, correct? So when we face this way, you guys just try that. If you only get the feet, that's great. Next time you'll get the feet and you'll shoot your hips around that way.
Five.
Here we go.
Six from the break.
Five, six, seven.
Right, left, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I hope we said this wasn't appropriate for minors because it's about to get sexy up in here. I'm about to get kicked off of YouTube. Here we go. Five,
okay.
Six, five, six, seven.
All right, sir.
Okay, I need one
quiet
bad. I want a better one.
It.
I want a better one. Five, six, five, six, seven.
Just for Peter this time. Right, left, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah, and then you just like this for the rest of the routine. Slow. No.
Let's do the whole bridge.
The whole bridge, which is?
Which is
boogie forward,
boogie back. Boogie forward, boogie back, break, get sexy.
Sort of, yeah. Let's do it a lot slower than that. Do you want to show it to the front or we just do it right away?
I think we should just do it.
With the music?
You know what, let's do this because we've gotten to the bridge. We're 3/4 of the way through the routine. Let's do this and then check in with the people again.
That sounds good.
Is that all right?
Mm-hmm.
Cue well. Ooh, now I have to find the bridge.
So we'll do it to the music, but to the actual part in the music where it'll hit, so you can hear
how
it
works. Agree. I'm crazy about my baby.
Yeah,
my little baby says about me. Pass and get your poker. Hold it in your hand. Full break. People say to look out. You can understand. It's an A1 combination.
First time's free, y'all.
It's
free.
Oh, I said A1 about my
boogie
baby,
forward.
Yeah, my little baby says about me. Pass and get your boca, hold it in your hand. Oh, baby, say to look out. You can understand, it's an A1 combination
with
the
times.
Perfect key and shape. My baby, yeah, my little baby says
about
me. Pass and get your boca, hold it in your hand. People say to look out.
Get
my little baby, please bow.
Pass
and get your boca. Hold it in your hand. People say to look out. You can understand. It's an A1 combination with the perfect
break time.
And she. Oh, I'm crazy.
Take a break
about
put some questions
baby.
In the comments. We'll check you out. See what's going on.
Here we go.
Tell me what can worry be? I'm crazy about my baby, and my baby's crazy about me. Mr. Cupid was our teacher, that's the reason we agree. I'm crazy about my baby, and my little baby crazy about me. Pass and get your book out, hold it in your hand. People say to look out, you can understand. It's an A1 combination with the perfect he and she. Oh, I'm crazy about my baby. Yeah, my baby's crazy about me.
All right, everybody.
Hi.
We are back.
Who's here? Who's here? Who's
once again,
here?
Check it out. If you guys want more videos and stuff, we are doing stuff on Patreon now. So
someone actually said hips don't lie. Oh, yes. Okay. We should point right here, patreon.com. If you guys are enjoying the class or you need a little more solo jazz in your life, we're teaching a live solo jazz class for our level 3 and up patrons next mm-hmm. week. So you should join in with that. They also get a bunch of other live events. We're doing a chat about the history of the scene tomorrow. We're also doing grab bag event at the end of the month. And mm-hmm. we've got instructional videos up. We've got music playlists that I put together. We've got a dance inspiration blog that we're really excited to share with you guys.
Yeah. So there's a couple questions out there, not too many. So someone wants to count with the steps of the break. We'll work on the break in a second. This break is often known as the TOBA break. Theater Owners Booking Association was a circuit of theaters that they owned the theaters. So the TOBA is like, that's the name of that break, TOBA break. They also called it Tough on Black Asses break. That's what Frankie said, because they were kind of cold-blooded back in the day. That's a classic break. It's been around for a long time. Kitty was asking if normally or at the end was more common. And you know, I don't actually know that. I've seen both done by kind of really experienced aged dancers, so I'm not sure which of those is more common.
Either one's fine. I'm sure there's some Lindy Hop statistician out there who wants to watch every old clip and figure out exactly what the percentage is, but we don't know. We just know we've seen both of those.
That's a good question, though. Both are viable, though. A step on 7/8, 6/7, or this.
Somebody else asked if we could count out the big break. And I would say that's actually kind of tricky.
Yeah, I think you're looking for numbers, and here's the thing.
It falls in between them.
It falls in between the numbers, so it's actually much better to make a scat sound. And the thing that is tricky about this is that depending on, I'm not saying you're an engineer, but it's so possible that you are. It's so possible.
We love you.
We can often, yeah, and so many dancers are. We have kind of brains that break these things down and like kind of, if I just knew the constituent elements, I could do the thing. That sometimes helps. But I would say that, again, when I think to the classes that I've taken with some of our Lindy Hop elders, they focus so much on a sound and a rhythm, they didn't focus on counts at all, and that was not just a lack of knowledge for them. That was a knowledge of something else that we don't always have great access to. I would say in this case, perhaps we could count it. It's way more useful for you to go bop, boom, bop, boom, bop, boom, bop, bop, bop. If you can write it down, that's way less important than if you can make that sound with your mouth. And if you make that sound with your mouth,
even more important, can you then do you it can with do your it. Feet?
Yeah. And what we find is that oftentimes when we use counts, we think they help you get to dancing. If it's just this step that you take randomly, it's not as useful. So I can't count that super well, and I actually find I've always skipped the counting of it because I feel like it skips a step that's not helpful, and it goes directly to the next step that is more helpful. That mnemonic, that sound, that scat, bop, boom, bop, boom, bop, boom, bop, bop, boom. If that becomes an earworm, your mouth can do it, your feet can do it soon after. You got to give yourself some chances with that.
I could maybe count it, but I don't think it would make you better at
not to be withholding, but it's really, it's not as helpful. And we've talked for a long time. Let's try it, and I want you all to try scatting it with us. Why don't we do it? Let's see if we can do it 4 times in a row.
Okay.
So after this, you can go right back into it. Let's do 4 times in a row, the T-O-B-A break. Scat it with us. 5, 6.
5, 6, 7,
takes practice. After a while, it feels super great, and you will do that rhythm all over the place. I think we should move on. I don't see any other big burning questions out there.
No, my only concern is we just did the break. The bridge. We didn't do the whole thing so far with music.
Why don't we take it from the top then?
All right.
And why don't we have you talk us through it, since I'm not going to remember it. So before we do music, can you just take us through one time,
okay,
nice and slowly?
Okay, one time we'll do it nice and slow. So everybody, we start with that lock turn. Then we go to the double kicks into the box step. Same thing other side. Double kick with the bounce to the box step. Now you put that foot out to the side. You go boom and boom. Paddle. Hitch, push,
step
push,
on
step
it.
On it. And paddle. You know what I mean, and paddle.
Now, boogie.
Full break.
You're right. I didn't remember, but you're right.
That's okay. You can just make it up right now.
Pretty close.
You can just make up for it right now.
All right.
That's the whole thing.
Let's try it together, everybody. I think the one link that you really got to find is after we do... It's after the paddle coming around the second time when you're here. You got to think about that as continuing into the boogie. Can you show how you sort of think of that? Because you taught that to me, and I was like, oh, that's a very helpful reminder.
Absolutely, and maybe we can practice just those 2 8s, because that's the one part we haven't practiced
yet.
That's a good
idea. That link. Let's do that.
So, if I'm showing it from the back, I'm going to go...
I'll let you show it.
Left paddle, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. So we've been doing moves that start on 1, but the next thing starts on 8. So you can't wait in between these two things. 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. You have to start right away. And something that helps remind me what I'm doing next is the paddle's going this way. And that's the same way my foot is gonna peel out to the side. So that can be a little reminder for you. Let's try the left side paddle into boogie forwards. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 1. You're so right. All right, let's try that again. One more time, that transition.
Second question.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and left, left, left step on it, boogie forward. So that's the one thing we haven't practiced, that transition. I think we should try the whole thing with music and see how we do.
Cool. Naomi, remind them when that paddle comes up.
I will. Just them?
Yes.
Okay, just them, not you.
No, I'm totally good.
Got it. Let me turn it up a little bit. This song is I'm Crazy About My Baby. By my band, Naomi.
You are.
And Devils. I am crazy about my baby.
Oh, wait, you're crazy about your literal baby.
And it's
me too, you guys.
Live at the Uptown Swingout, which is the event that Peter runs. Here
That's
we go.
Right. Don't miss it.
6, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Swing it.
Kick. I'm the world's most happy creature. Tell me what can worry be. I'm
Nailing
crazy
it.
By my baby.
Yes, I shouldn't worry about
the crazy about the side. Mr. Cupid was our teacher. That's the reason we agree. I'm crazy about my baby. Get my little baby forward. Forward. Pots to get your boca. Hold it in your hand. Keep a steady lookout. You can understand. It's an A1 combination.
Okay, let's try that again.
Yeah, I could use one more time.
Oh, I'm crazy about.
Let's do this. Let's turn around.
I was
around.
Like trying to center myself, and I should just do the routine.
I know. One thing at a time. Let's turn around so they can
sure.
watch our feet from the back.
Sure,
here
sure,
we go,
sure.
everybody.
Watch me mess up from the back.
Lock turn, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, tables up. Kick.
I'm the world's most happy creature.
Box.
Tell me what can worry
me. Same thing, other side.
I'm crazy about my baby, and my baby's crazy about
the side.
Mr. Cupid was our teacher.
How?
That's the reason we agree. I'm crazy about my baby, and my baby's crazy about me.
Boogie
Pass
forward.
To get your book up.
Full break.
Keep a steady lookout. You can understand. It's an A1 combination with the perfect he and she. Oh, I'm crazy about my baby. Yeah, my baby's crazy about me.
Let's take it one more time.
One more time, and then we'll talk about that next.
And watch what we do next. We will teach it, but just take a watch. From the top with us. We'll go on one tiny bit further. We're almost to the end.
5, 6, 7, 8.
I'm the world's most happy creature. Tell me what can worry be? I'm crazy about my baby, and my baby's crazy about
that.
Mr. Cupid was our teacher. That's the reason we agree.
Again.
I'm crazy about my baby, and my little baby's crazy about me.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Hold it in your hand.
Full break.
Keep a steady lookout.
Did you get it? All right.
All right, everybody, let's work on that next bit there. Okay, so we went bop, bop, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Stomp, stomp, ah, ah.
So we're stomping our right foot on 8.
Mm-hmm.
And we're using that same foot, that right foot, to step on next.
And Amy, I think this might be a place where numbers would be helpful.
Sure.
Because it's just like a time to do the move. Can you count the numbers for us?
Yeah.
5, 6, 7.
8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. 8, 1, 2, 3.
Let's keep going.
4, 5, 6.
Join
and
in.
7. Try with us. 4, 5, 6, and 7. Stomp off. Same foot. Step, step. Right foot. Right foot. Right left. Left foot, left foot,
step,
left
step,
right.
Step,
hey, ho.
One more. Last time. Cool. Hope that's coming. So when we do that, sort of like the uptown sort of thing a little bit.
It's like a lot of different things.
So a lot of stuff.
But so we'll just treat it as its own thing today so we don't confuse it too much. Just make sure the foot you're stomping is the foot that you step on first.
You know, what I would like to do is I would like to do the full break, that T-O-B-A break, do that into the sexy time, into the stomp. Because when you're doing sexy time, you can get a little lost in your own sexiness and you have to find count number 8 to hit that stomp. So
Sounds
why don't
good.
You and I show that right quick to the front and then we'll do it to the back.
Okay.
5, 6, break.
Full break.
Ha, 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 ha.
Get sexy.
Five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, you guys try with us now. We'll face this way. Here we go. From the break. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7.
Get sexy. 5, 6, 7. Step, step, triple step. Step, step, triple step. One more time?
I think at least.
Here we go. Full break. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Get sexy. 5, 6, 7. Hop on. Hop on. One more time, super slow. 5.
Do you want to do the next thing and show them or no?
No. You and me?
No, let's not.
No.
Okay, you're so right. Here we go.
I didn't say no until you said no.
I know, but you meant no and you're right.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. Ha, ha. Get sexy, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I'll just say when I'm doing this get sexy time, bop, 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 bop. I often like do two feet because I'm a little wide, and so I could just step over here, but I like to be where I am. So I can do that. That's optional. If you see me do that, you don't have to do it. I just like it.
I try to get sexy all the way back to the left side so that my right leg is free. That helps me do that transition.
Probably do it like Naomi. Two choices. Two choices, y'all. All right, cool. So, I think we should show the next thing now.
Yep.
Because we've been stomping on that eight, and now we're not going to. This sort of messed me up for a while. So if we know to not do it, that would help.
We're gonna do a little half a turn, one and a half a turn, a half a turn, a half a turn. And it's gonna fit the music. And I know exactly what the music's doing underneath my singing here because I wrote this part.
That's so right.
The part goes, should I show it?
Why don't you show it? Sure, sure.
It goes 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3, 5, 7. That be, that be, that.
Let's all clap that together a couple times. You do it and we're gonna come with you.
So I'm me and you are the people?
Yes, sure.
Okay, so I
That's appropriate because you're gonna do it right every time and I'm optional. Here we go.
So I'll go, then you go. One more time. I like that rhythm.
It's getting funky right there.
Now we actually have to do a turn while we do it. You know when you're clapping, you're like, I think I got it. Now we got to do a turn. So we go. Kick, cross, twist, turn, land.
Why don't we do just the first time part?
Sure.
For one second. Because not everyone's been dancing a million years. You know, some of the people are intermediate. So we'll just see how it goes.
So should we go kick, cross, twist?
I think that much.
Okay.
And when we land, we're going to land kind of wound up. So that'll be on eight, that kick.
Mm-hmm.
So we go
kick, eight, one, cross, two, three.
And let's get kind of like, so not totally flat like this. Okay, remember front is here for now. It's back here. So when we're doing this, we're with you. We're going to kick on it. Watch us. We go 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3. And you want to be kind of wound up because you're going to go back. But let's just get to there.
You'll start looking at us. You'll end not facing us.
Let's get that kick on eight, everybody. It's important.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Bop, bop, bop. Again, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Bop, bop, bop. This time, you can turn around and face us. This time, let's do this. Bop, 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 boom. And we hop onto our right foot. We won't turn. We'll just make sure we hop onto our right foot.
And Naomi, if I'm not mistaken, that right foot is directly underneath you. You don't move over to get it.
Correct. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Kind of moving over to get it, but okay.
Oh, sorry.
Can you just do the step how you do it?
Ah.
Yeah, because when you're showing it like this, you're showing it a little different. So we just want
to be clear. Am I showing it like teacher showing
yes,
it?
Yes, you're doing it weird teacher showing
sorry.
It. So don't do that. So when you're here, your right leg's here. You don't go get it. You bring it right underneath your center. Can you show it like that one time without turning?
Yes.
I think you can do it, yeah.
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3, 5.
Let's do that, okay?
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3, 5. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3. Your right leg.
Mm-hmm. One more.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3. Your right leg. I think we should just do half a turn to start with.
Okay.
So we'll go 8, 1, 3, 5, 7.
So it's all that bounce, bounce. The mm-hmm. bouncing, again, like the down up, like in so many things, it's to get the timing. It's not about getting a huge amount of height. The height is required for the timing. So we're going to get that.
Boom, bop, boom, bop.
Want to sound just like we clapped. Here we go. We'll
five,
do a half turn of it.
6, 5, 6, 7. Pop, boom, pop, boom,
half turn.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7.
Should be really easy to do that half turn. One whole turn is going to be a little trickier.
Let's try half one more time.
Uh-huh.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Ha, 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 ha. All right, now we're going to go just a half turn more.
I got to fix my sweaty back.
Ha, 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 ha. So you end up facing the back. So if you start facing us on your computer, you'll end up facing away from your computer. We're just gonna do one more eight after that. It's like our exit move. So that's why I turned you around. So watch me one more time do it. You just turn around. Same way you were facing when you wound
so
up.
So gotta use that wind up to get going the other way.
Here we go. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey, ha. One more time. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Ha, boom. Oh, sorry,
ow,
I hit you.
That hurt.
I said one more time, but I just said that to say it. Yeah. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Ha, oh, ha, oh, ha.
Cool.
Okay.
Let's link that next thing.
We only have 1 8 left.
You know what? Actually, I think the link that we need is the one right before. Because we're stomping, and you get, ooh, I'm feeling good. Stomping, and you're stomping, and you think you should go. And we got to know that it's a kick instead of a stomp.
Okay.
So can you and I just show this? Watch it. We do that stomp thing 2 times. And then the third time we come around, we hit that eight, it's that kick into the turn we just did. Five, six, seven, you right and me.
Foot. Left foot, kick your right foot. And hey, ho, hey, ho.
Try it with us. Okay. You know the parts. Here we go.
From
five,
the stomp.
Six, five,
right
six,
right foot. Ba-ba-wa-ba-da, left foot. Kick it, kick, cross, turn, hey, ho.
I got lost. I was so happy to be here.
It's
again.
Okay. It's okay.
One more time. I have to do a whole turn the way back. Okay. Now I know.
Five, six. Stomp your right foot. Hey, hop. Oh, whack it out. Left foot. Don't stomp. Kick it. Kick. Boom. Ba. Boom. Ba.
I'm turning way too much. Sorry.
You did one and a half. Here's the thing.
I'm really excited about the turn.
When you wind up. Wherever you're facing when you wind up, that's what you come around to see again. So it's really just a full turn.
Good note, Naomi. Thanks. Turn, I'll write that down.
that might help, you know, anyone.
Was anyone else turning one and a half?
Or one half or three quarters of a turn.
Three quarters of a turn.
Three quarters of a turn.
Okay. Let's try that again for Petey, huh?
All right. From the stomps.
So wherever you face on the wind up, that's what you're going to face on the turn, Naomi.
Five, six, five, six, seven. Kick it. Hey, home. Come back here.
That's easy. I've been turning way too much.
All right, let's just add the last eight because we're at time pretty much, even though we started a little
late. Can we practice the last eight by itself?
Yes. So the last eight we actually took from Norma Miller. She does this a lot in her routines. It's like a hitch step into an Applejacks or anything, but we just go into twists. So I go eight and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. If you've taken a class with Norma, you might have done it before. So what's weird about it, followers, is you end up twisting the weird way on your left on one. Don't worry about it too much. You're going to the left side just like you would. Just like you would on a shorty George. So watch us. Five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So we're going kick and step.
Hey, why don't I go like a tiny bit behind you so I don't smack you in the face every time?
Behind me? Behind me.
Well, it depends on which way we face that.
Kippy, you go like this.
But I'm so much bigger that I look weird in the camera.
All right, sir. You guys getting this?
Can you guys see her? I'm too big. Okay. So just that much. That last step. Five, six, seven. One more.
Make sure you're getting over to the left side on one. Five, six, five, six, seven. Kick right, left.
That's your big exit.
Exactly.
So now we will try. Let's show them the last two eights.
Just the last two eights?
I think so.
Okay.
Well, that's all I can remember right now, so they're probably in a similar boat. So let's do just the kicking one. Five, six, five, six, seven, ha. Do you want to try it now? Here we go. Five, six, five, six, seven, ha. Ooh.
Face this way.
Still not good, but I did do it.
All right. I think they should get a chance to practice it too.
Yep.
Let's face this way. You guys come along with us, the last two eights. Five, six, kick your legs. Six, seven, eight, ho, ha, hoo, ha, ah, 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 ah. Let's try that again. Five, six, seven, ha, hoo, ha, hoo, ha, ah, 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 ah.
And that should be us exiting. We're out of there.
We're like exiting through the back of the stage.
Right, exiting through the back of the stage. So. We're going to tape this next time because this is driving me insane. Let's take the last four eights, that last phrase, shall
we? We're going to go from the stomps, everybody. This is the, I would say, the trickiest phrase, so be kind to yourself if you're not getting it right away. You can always go back and watch the video again. Five, six from the stomps. Six, seven, eight, one. Boom, boom, wakada. Eight, one. Don't speed up. Boom, boom, wakada. Hey, boom, ah, boom, ah.
Did she mess up that time? Did you mess up, please?
let's just take it again. No one will ever know. No one okay. can rewind the video.
But I honestly need to know. You messed up, right?
I don't know.
Just like, did I face the right
did.
Way?
I probably did.
We're going to review the evidence on that. But so Naomi, we're start. This is front. So when we do our little half turn, it's here. And then we come around to the full turn, which is here. So here we go. Okay, now we both know. Let's see what happens. Wish us luck, everybody. Are we doing this? Why don't we show it one more time? No. Everyone do it with us, and if you don't mess it up, you're better than we are. Here we go, five, six, it's the end of the workshop, y'all, we're getting to the end. Here we go, five, six, a five, six, loopy, hoo, ah, 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 hoo, hoo, oh, oh,
kick it, come back to here,
so easy.
Here's the thing. When we totally screwed up, they were facing the other way, so we should just keep going,
Well, we were both facing different ways, which is a problem.
And so. Think of all the people that were watching on the couch. They literally screwed up.
They're just laughing.
Same thing, everybody. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Stomp it out. Stomp it out. Kick your foot. Ha, oh, come to here. Oh, ah, ba, ba, da,
What if we went not so fast one time?
What if we...
Because they're learning.
Knew that it was 3:04 and we went back a little bit. We could do the bridge and this.
Sure. But right. Slower. Take a little time to think through it. The bridge is what?
Boogie forward, boogie back.
Let's show them. 5, 6, just us now, boogie forward. Let's keep this tempo.
Full
you
break.
Know the break.
Get sexy.
Can't help yourself. Not so fast.
Kick it. Come to here.
That's the end. All right, everyone try that with us. We're going to face this way just to confuse ourselves.
All right.
The last phrase.
We are screwing up, but we are facing a different way almost every time, so.
It's true.
Do they care? No, but it's true.
So true.
Here we go. 5, 6, 7.
Hey! Here comes the break.
Keep a steady lookout. You can understand.
Stop your foot.
It's an A1 combination with the perfect he and she.
Kick it.
Oh, I'm crazy.
Come to
about my baby. And my baby's crazy about me.
Nice, y'all. Let's try that again.
My baby, yeah, my little baby says about me. Pass and get your boca. Hold it in your hand.
Full break.
Keep a steady lookout. So you can understand. It's an A1 combination with the perfect he and she. Oh, I'm crazy about my baby. Yeah, my baby's crazy about me.
I think we should get practice from the top.
Mm-hmm.
But because we're running out of time, I would love to show the more advanced dancers just a couple things they can try. And it can be a little bit of homework. You can always rewind. We're going to have this up on Facebook. We're going to have it up on YouTube. We're going to have it up on Instagram Live, so you can always go back and check it out.
That is correct, Mundo.
So one thing that you can mess with if you want to make things harder is on the box steps. That's a really simple step. There's actually a little box step video on our Patreon, an instructional video that shows you how to dress it up. And one of those ways is triple step and putting a knee slap in there. So.
Yeah, I'm gonna try that one.
Yep, I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, and then I can start kicking. You know what, I'll try it from this side.
Okay, I'll get out of the way.
Watch me one more time. 1, 3, 5, and 6, 7, 8, and then we can start kicking again. Try that with me if you want. If you don't get it right away, that's okay. This is a choose your own adventure moment. Left foot crossing over. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and hey, ho, triple step, knee slap, hey. And you can try it on the other side if you want, hey, et cetera, et cetera.
Why don't we try both of those just one time and link them, yeah? So we're gonna do the box step with the left, all the way through the box step with the right, into the kicks again.
Well, let's just go from the top of the chorus then.
Okay.
Okay, so we're gonna start with our double kicks on the right, everybody.
Show them the whole thing. Show them the thing. Girl, we don't have a studio time. We can go late. Turn around, face front, let's show it. 5, 6, 7, we got
double.
No one cares.
Triple step, knee slap, double. Triple step, knee slap, and
Let's try that much, everybody. Just one time, and if you get it now, that's great. If you don't, you can practice it later. Here we go from the double kicks. 5, 6. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Double. Here we go. Triple step, knee slap, hey. Triple step, knee slap, Ooh, sorry. This.
Cool.
And this.
That's one thing to spice it up. I think there's two more spices, is that correct?
Let's do one more spicy.
Okay.
So the next spicy is 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. You can just take those two steps and turn with them.
And your helpful advice to me was turn in place. And don't try and lead the turn with your foot. Just pick your foot up.
You're going to want to turn this way. And I really think of turning right behind myself. And I let myself turn on that last triple step. I'm not done in those two steps. I just started in those two steps, and I'm still coming around.
So it's four counts to turn, triples. Not two counts.
Let's try those nice and slow.
Try it with us, yeah.
five, six.
This one's very doable.
Five, six, seven. Try a couple more.
It's good.
All right.
It's good. I think that's very doable. If you get it now, that's great. Again, it can just be homework. Is that all we want to do for the complications? We leave it?
I think so. And if we had more time, we'd practice some more. But that's just for the people who are getting the routine, nailing it every time.
Mm-hmm. All you yawners out there are like, it's so easy.
It's so easy for
something
my couch.
Else to challenge.
All right. Let's try it a couple times from the top.
From the tippity top, y'all. Here we go. Here we go. Let's get back to some break.
Five, six, seven, eight. Kick. I'm the world's most happy creature. Tell me what can the world be? I'm crazy about my baby. Yeah, my baby's crazy about step to the side. Mr. Cupid was our teacher. That's the reason we agree. I'm crazy about my baby. Yeah, my little baby crazy about me. Posse, get your book up. In your hand. All right. People say to look up.
Get sexy.
You can understand.
Your foot.
It's an A1 combination with the perfect he and she.
Kick.
Oh, I'm crazy about my baby. And my baby's crazy about me.
Nice. Let's go more times. See how we do.
My baby. Yeah, my little baby. Crazy.
Tippy on the tip top tippy.
You're so right. You're so, so right. Here we go.
Here we go, everybody.
Five, six, seven, eight. Okay. I'm the world's most happy creature. Tell me what can worry be? I'm crazy about my baby. Yeah, my baby's crazy about me. Mr. Cupid was our teacher. That's the reason we agree. I'm crazy about my baby. Yeah, my little baby crazy about me. Posse, get your book up. Hold it in your hand.
Over it.
People say to look up.
Get sexy.
You can understand.
Your foot.
It's an A1 combination with the perfect he and she.
Kick.
Oh, I'm crazy about my baby. Yeah, my baby's crazy about me.
All right. I think we should try one more time.
Yeah.
Maybe not. But here's the thing. Peter, before we do it, our one last time,
yes.
Can we just say, if you're enjoying the class, we would love for you to donate to these two great organizations. If you're not enjoying the class,
still
we would
donate.
Love
it's
for you to donate
fault.
To these two great organizations.
It's not their fault, class sucks.
Can you just super quick say what organizations we're working
on? Once again, we're donating to Equal Justice Initiative. They're working to end mass incarceration and unjust punishment and get rid of the death penalty. They're doing really great work. Brian Stevens is the name to look up. Just Mercy is his book and his movie. It's out right now. Really, really great organization. If you saw the new Dave Chappelle special, that's what he's donating to. It's a great organization. And then locally, we're donating to the Northside Achievement Zone, and they're working to end generational poverty in the Northside, which is the really underserved part of Minneapolis. And they're doing really great work. They get kids, and they basically work with these kids, but also the kids' whole family. And they don't just do school. They do everything, the whole life, a real holistic approach to helping these kids. And it's been shown the longer the kids stay with the program, the better they do. So it's two really great causes, and it's a time where we need to act. Like I said before, we always say during Black History Month, if you love Lindy Hop, you love Black History. I don't know if everyone recognizes that it follows that if you love Black History, you love Black culture. You love Black lives. You love Black people. That shit is just all true with or without you. So as a Lindy Hop community, it's really important to me that we stand up and we actually take some action. This thing we're doing is a pitiful little bit of action, but it's a start. And I hope you guys can do some more as well. We hope to put our bodies on the line a little bit more, especially as the pandemic wears off. But right now, donating can be a great way to help.
Thank you guys so, so much for tuning in. If you want some more live classes or instructional videos with us, you can find it on Patreon. But for now, if you want to donate, please donate to those two organizations. And stay tuned to all our different spots. We'll definitely be posting in the comments of each spot how much money we raise.
We're going to do this thing one more time?
Yeah.
One more time for all the marbles, everybody.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Full tempo.
Let's do it.
You want to play it at home? I'm crazy about my baby.
Here we go.
I'm the world's most happy creature. Tell me what can we be? I'm crazy about my baby.
Yeah,
my baby's crazy about me.
I'll just tell you guys, like, our parents just showed up with the baby, so I'm a little stressed out. But don't bring her in yet. I lost a little focus there. Sorry. Here we go.
One last time, and then it's baby.
If you do this one, you get baby. Here we go. I really blew it so hard. I didn't have to stop. Dingy, let's go.
Here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay. I'm the world's most happy creature. Five. Tell me, what can worry be? I'm crazy about my baby, and my baby's crazy about me. Mr. Cupid was our teacher. That's the reason we agree. I'm crazy about my baby, and my little baby crazy about me. Posse, get your book up, hold it in your hand. Oh, baby, say to look up, get sexy. You can understand. It's an A1 combination with the perfect he and she. Oh, I'm crazy about my baby, and my baby's crazy about me.
Thank you guys so much for joining us. I hope you had a great time. We hope to do some more of this stuff in the future. Right now, let's see if we can get that baby in here. If you made it to the end, you deserve a little bit of Cora face. Hold! Got it. You guys, it's true. I really am crazy about my baby. Hey, sweetheart. Wanna say hi? Say hello! Can you say hello to the people?
Hey! I'm walking on air.
Yeah! Where are you? Did you have a good time? Can you say hello into my mic? Can I have a kiss? Can I have a kiss?
Frankie!
She's learning, Frankie. Who's this?
We just put this up yesterday. She's been a little obsessed.
What are you chewing on?
Goldfish. Okay. It's not very
cool. There you go. Have a hug.
Thank you guys so much for joining us here today.
Are we going to end
the transition? Do you want to play a little stuff from the organizations?
Yeah, it's a little somber, but we're showing off this baby for all the people who made it. Checking these things here. Thanks you guys so much for coming. I'm just checking these comments, making sure we get everybody here.
Thank you. Thank you, Terry. Thank you, Maggie. Thank you, Sarah. Shout out to Sarah for being our very first donator before we started the workshop.
That's right, good work.
Absolutely.
That was awesome. Maddie, there you go, you get it.
Elizabeth, Attila.
You earned it.
Hey, we're getting people from all over the world.
Woo!
Tony, Andrew, thank you guys so much for coming and watching us
Attila's
sweat.
Ready. Thanks, guys. We're gonna put a little video about the two organizations that we're donating for. Check them out. Enjoy.
Remember, you can donate to us or you can donate direct to the organization.
In 1989, about 25% of the people executed in the United States were executed in the state of Alabama. We had dozens of people on death row who did not have legal representation. There were no institutions providing legal services to condemn people. If you don't have a right to counsel, and you don't have any money, and you're on death row, you're going to be executed.
It's stunning that a country that's so dedicated to incarceration as a solution for its problems knows so little about who we lock up, why, and for how long.
The people on death row had no help, had no assistance. If we didn't work on the cases, no one was going to work on the cases. In the late 80s, the Equal Justice Initiative was created as an organization to help people on death row. Over time, being exposed to a lot of other injustices in the criminal justice system led us to branch out and try to create programs and initiatives to confront the other problems outside of the death penalty context.
Imposing a sentence of life imprisonment without parole isn't a life sentence, it's a death sentence. It's a death in prison sentence. We've done a lot of work for people who've been sentenced to die in prison, people whose convictions and sentences have not been reliably imposed.
February 2nd of 2005, I gave birth at home to a stillborn son, Timothy, and then I was convicted of capital murder. And for the next 10 years, all of my 40s, I spent in the Tutwiler Women's Prison. Equal Justice Initiative believed me when no one else would. they represented me during my appeal process. The Alabama Supreme Court had my sentence overturned. My release date was December 12th of 2012. It was a wonderful day. I'm home with my children. I'm home with my family.
In the late 90s, we started challenging the way poor people are not provided adequate legal assistance. Our criminal justice system treats you better if you're rich and guilty than if you're poor and innocent. Wealth, not culpability, shapes outcomes. And we think that we have to change that.
I was convicted in 2000 for drug trafficking, which was a crime that I didn't commit. They sentenced me life without parole. I got in touch with EJI. They said, we're going to work for you, and we're going to get you out of here. And I cried. I just cried because it was just overwhelming to know that somebody was actually there to help me. August the 17th of 2006, I was released, and it just was so surreal. It was just so surreal.
The young girl who was 14 years old wrote to us and said, I've been sentenced to life without parole. Can you help me? And that was the beginning of our project challenging life without parole as an unconstitutional sentence for children.
The United States is the only country in the world that condemns children to die in prison, some as young as 13 years of age. We've seen real progress. 8 years ago, we were executing children in the United States. And in 2005, the U.S. Supreme Court banned the execution of children. In 2010, we were able to persuade the court to ban life imprisonment without parole for children convicted of non-homicides. Now the court has banned these mandatory death in prison sentences for all children. We started a project on race and poverty, where we're looking at the legacy of racial inequality and injustice in America. We partner with schools, other advocacy groups and organizations who are all interested in education around these issues of race and poverty.
We try to organize people to act on the injustice, speak out on these issues, and raise awareness.
It's too easy to say that something is complicated, it's difficult, it's been that way forever, and tolerate it. We can create a more just society, but it doesn't happen by itself. It is not inevitable.
For me to be sitting here, it's a miracle. I get up every day, and whatever I look at, I'm not looking at it through a chain link fence. And you can't explain that to someone.
I began working in North Minneapolis in the early 90s, during a period of time when nationally we became known as Murderapolis because of all the violence that was erupting almost overnight in North Minneapolis. So I quickly realized that the issues that we were facing were deep and pervasive and required solutions that were deep and pervasive.
We're not well. We're not well. We're not. And when we're not mentally, physically, and spiritually well, there's no hope.
Minnesota usually is one, two, or third in the country in ACT scores. We're worst in graduating kids of color from high school.
For so many generations of people, they've never seen someone from their family graduate from college. They've never seen their ability to actually be in poverty and escape.
The problem didn't happen overnight. It's gonna take just as much time as it did to create the problem, to have a solution and work through that problem.
So the Northside Achievement Zone is a collaborative of 33 community-based organizations and 8 schools. And we are working together in a results-driven fashion, holistic approach to end multi-generational poverty, using education and whole family support as the two levers.
When parents don't have the proper resources at home, it contributes to children being unprepared for school. Problems with housing, employment, food, or health deprives a child of the proper rest or nutrition, which can lead to poor academic performance. When a family comes to NAS, we enroll them all to provide them with the support they need to solve these problems. The parents work with the family coach to help them set and achieve specific goals. The family coach gets them started in NAS by working with them to create their own achievement plan, which connects them to our parenting education and empowerment classes and to our 40-plus partner organizations who support them to achieve their goals centered around education, housing, jobs, and health. At the same time, the student will work one-on-one with their NAS coach to set their own goals for success. Then we gather data to measure their success and make sure all the pieces are working together to support families as they lift themselves out of poverty and move their children along a path to college.
To have NAS to be able to bring all those different resources to the table instead of having to contact all these individual locations and the family coach working with this family to help them navigate housing, to help them navigate employment, helps to stabilize a family.
And when you have people that are from the community, that are working within the community, you are going to have a profound level of understanding and relatability that is not achieved by outsiders.
Whether or not NAS existed or not, the needs of our scholars and families, that doesn't change. And so the fact that they bring us all to the table for a common goal of serving this community, that has tremendous power.
They built a great network, a great group of partners, and literally neighborhood by neighborhood, they're making a difference today.
They're our future workforce, and this is future economic prosperity for our region. So yes, it's the right thing to do, but it's the smart thing to do for the economic future of our community.
My neighbors who live on my block are not the same as they were yesterday. And they are believing that it is possible that their outcomes for their families, themselves, and for our community can be vastly different than they are today.
You see that connection, and that shows you, like, that's a NAS family. They might say something, be like, that's a NAS family. Have you ever heard of NAS? Yeah, I'm a NAS family, I knew it.
Being a NAS family makes me feel special. Makes me feel cared for.
I got the answers that I needed just from this organization.
I got the biggest support system ever with NAS.
And I just feel like without NAS, I don't know where I would be.
Everywhere I go, I'm plugging NAS.
Because NAS is not looking at an individual person, they're looking at the whole family. And it starts within the family.
The data that we're seeing says that the more children in the North Side, you know, are exposed to what NAS is doing and the programs and the resources that we offer, the more they're exposed to that, the better they do in school, the better the outcomes.
So I'd ask many others that are part of this great community to recognize the opportunity to work with NAS. And while we always give back to the communities we serve, starting here at home is critically important.
There is not one solution. And so what we've done through the Northside Achievement Zone is we've brought together a myriad of solutions. And we brought them together for the same family and the same children, and it is working.
So we got to catch up. And hopefully when we have this discussion in 20 years, I don't have this job, right? NAS doesn't exist except in history books. Look what NAS helped do, but we inevitably shouldn't be here, right? Something else should be on the corner of Penn and West Broadway 20 years from now.